couple in the city, and they were just frothing on all cylinders. Photos in here. I just got sent a photo of them at the airport. Dad's got the backpack on with the sensible strap done up in the middle.
Paper tickets.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. They'd have the little passport belts on, you know what I mean?
So first time overseas? Like, first time Europe?
No, they've been to the UK. Dad hasn't been to Europe, though. So, like,
This is an enlightening trip.
A mate of mine, his old man hadn't left the country his entire life. Gets to about 74. He's a concrete truck driver. And he got to about 74, and they were like, let's go over to Europe. Let's see what's going on. You know, they're Catholic. It's like, let's go to cathedrals. And
There's a lot for you people to see over
there. Yeah, there is for us. They get over there 6 weeks, do everything, come home, and my mate went to pick him up from the airport. His dad gets off the plane, threw his passport at my mate and goes, won't be needing that again. they're driving down Parramatta Road back home to Burwood, and he's pointing out the window going like, look, that's better than anything you're going to get. Pointing at like a motel, you know.
Fuck yeah.
That's a man that's been institutionalized. You know what I mean?
Like, what's the old guy in Shawshank?
Yeah. Fucking.
Brooks.
Brooks was here.
It's full Brooks mode.
Yeah, that's Brooks stuff. The world's just passed him by.
You got to also respect, you know, a man that knows and appreciates his station. It's like,
yeah,
man, Europe's good, but
Parramatta Road?
Burwood?
Yeah.
Have you seen this place on Lunar New Year?
We're in about 20 different catchments. Schools are fucking everywhere.
Dude, the catchment thing is actually fucking bullshit. I didn't even know catchments existed for a school thing.
You can't move around, mate.
My daughter's going to school next year, and there's like two fucking schools in Bondi, and she can only get into one. I'm like, but we want to go to the other one, because that's where all her mates are at. And they're like, nah. Or you got to wait until like the week before school starts before they let you in. I had no idea.
It's highly political. Like the yarn in Byron when Damon moved there, it was like everyone was filthy because Damon's kid like got shortlisted to get into the school.
Matt Damon.
And everyone was filthy about it, and it was the talk of the town because obviously Byron, you know, the millionaires have been replaced by billionaires. and then whatever it happened, and then it became like the bragging point that our kid goes to school with Matt Damon. It's like, yeah. First you had an issue with it, now you love it.
But also it's like, shut up, we're letting Matt Damon's kid come in. Like, relax, dude.
Let's not pretend like that's not how the world works. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I mean, he's a smart fella. The kid's going to do wonders for the NAPLAN up there or whatever the fuck it is.
You know? Don't have any fucking chalkboards around.
Oh, fuck.
A reminder, the punter, the dribbler, if you want to match up with us, just use the scoreboard in the top right corner.
Scoreboard's there. Scoreboard. Well,
scoreboard.
Clock. Scoreboard. Clock. Well, it's both.
Just want to get an update on how you're feeling, though, Tom.
Yeah. Just before we went to air. Look, Eddie and I have been playing pool in this office for fucking 2 and a bit years now. We haven't played for a while. Not an excuse or anything. I'm just setting the scene. Context is always important. We haven't played for probably like 7 months. And we got back on there. We started playing. And for the first time in the history of the room, in the table, I lost without sinking a ball.
Swept.
Nudie run?
Swept. People are saying nudie run.
Well, yeah, we didn't set a rule, though, about it. So, unfortunately...
But people are just saying...
Well, sure. And I'm going to say... Kind of like... I'm going to kindly say no.
You go prime yourself and then... You know.
Look, so some blood in it and then just get out on the shit. Sit on the
blood in that thing.
Just a quiet joke and then fuck it off you go. Yeah. I think nudie runs are a very early noughties kind of punishment.
Yeah. They're for the youth.
When you lose, too, and you have to... Like, you have to as a youth... Mm. It's the absolute pits.
I had to run naked through 5 ways in Paddington.
When?
Dude, this would have been when I was like 20. Actually, it might have been like 19. I reckon it was like 19, 20. And I don't know what, I was fucked. And I ran up from where I used to live at the time. And I had to do this loop, ran through 5 ways, like 7:30, 8:30 at night, packed. And
that's really good shit.
And then down and back home. It was actually exhilarating. I'm not going to lie.
Like an East Rugby thing?
Mate, I think it was like a couple of mates around and there was a fucking bet going.
You were drunk enough to play pool in your 20s.
Yeah.
Was it arms up? Let it hang out, or
no, dude. It was cover your fuck, cover what you've got,
and the spidey legs.
Yeah, yeah. Cover what you've got, and just hope to Christ that you know it does enough.
It doesn't slip out.
Well, exactly. It you know, doesn't cascade out of your hand. Oh, Jesus Christ! Yeah, no, that's a. I mean, I'm not a huge nudie run guy since that night. I don't know if that would shock anyone.
I think I had to do one in Redfern back in the day.
Well, you sent, us a really tasteful nude the other day on our fitness chat group.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, yeah, I actually might have run an eye over that fan.
Grey sweats? What are we talking about?
It actually reminded me a lot of that time you posted in your like touring DJ era. Remember when that famous photo came up of Kim Kardashian and Emma Ratajkowski in the bathroom with the blocked out. Oh, and then you posted a nude with you, and you made it really long. Similar to that.
I had to do that.
Yeah, yeah, that was
necessary.
Necessity.
Yeah. I just cropped it a little bit. I gave him a bit of stem. Yeah. Now, I have props.
Oh, you bought props?
What have you brought?
Well, first prop is, because it's a Queensland fiesta tonight.
Oh, Broncos on the charge here. Oh, no, that looks like
something. You got some more photos of John Eels?
Queensland Fiesta. Where's the camera? So you'll see on this hat, this is Wynnum Manly Seagulls.
Yeah.
Just paying tribute to the original comp, the BRL, wow, that was fucking okay, bastardized by this piece of shit. And then we lost all of our great players from this comp to these two teams. But... obviously, Broncos have a soft spot in my heart. But right, also,
so do the Rabbitohs.
So do the Storm, though, right? And so this is...
How the fuck did the Storm have a soft spot in your heart?
No, this is the... You can wear this. This is the struck off premiership scarves.
Okay.
But I also have another piece of Melbourne Storm history in this bag. And I ran into a young bloke that most of you might know.
I know exactly where you got all this shit from.
This young bloke by the name of Dior Dave, who is one of the loudest and proudest they have in terms of fans. And what he's given me is, and this is dribbly by him. I don't know if you guys know this about him.
So is
this is the Melbourne Storm theme yarmulke that he had his thumb for. He had it. This deal.
Look at that.
2011.
Dude.
That's how young he was.
Oh, my God.
Melbourne Storm yarmulke.
So good. Has he given you permission to wear that?
I'm going
to
play the role as like a religious Melbourne Storm fan. Here we
are. That's nice, dude. Well done, Dave.
Oh, you look good, mate.
Dave's still contributing from beyond the grave. I like it.
No, I like that.
A Melbourne Storm yarmulke.
Mm.
He used to bring us in like Jewish food and stuff. Yeah, we used to have a cultural corner with Dio.
We did. We tried some of the breads.
Yeah, they weren't great. No disrespect.
It was a flatbread. It's a flatbread, right?
Yeah, well, yeah. Right. I wouldn't even call it bread.
It's unleavened bread.
Yeah.
Listen, I wouldn't be going back, but
no,
it did the job.
Yeah, it was nice.
It was nice.
A nice gesture, anyway.
Well, it was nice that he brought it in.
Yeah,
and it was nice to eat it with him, but again,
not nice tasting.
You know, if it's Saturday morning and the missus says, "Go get some bread for avocado and toast," I'm probably not getting it.
It's like the wafer when you're so hungry as a young kid. You're like, maybe. Maybe that'll feel better if I eat the
body of Christ.
And it doesn't do shit. And you don't get drunk. But you tell yourself these things to get through the day.
Yeah, I mean, like the Catholic Church, they've done a lot to reform pretty much since Vatican II. But really,
they've done quite a bit.
Put some fucking salt in the body of Christ.
Yeah,
and
dude,
all of a sudden, you're going to have a fair bit of like repeat business.
Yeah. Christ needed maybe some bacon
chicken salt.
Yeah.
Chicken salt.
Oh, shit.
Oh! Idiot!
There's a bit going on in this game. It's actually not too bad.
Trizzy.
Bit of back and forth. Broken field play.
That's a quick 10 minutes. That's a quick 10 minutes.
Yeah, thing's flying.
Good kick. Oh, no, didn't kick it.
No, just he does eventually.
Jerome.
Try scorer still hasn't hit yet. Eddie, who do you have? Nick Meaney?
I had Nick Meaney, yeah.
I've got Adam Reynolds at 34. Ooh. Glorious.
What's Trizzy playing? I'll back Trizzy.
Tristan Well, you won't be able to do it now because the game's already started and you'll have to call up, which is very dribbly. Like, that's actually
and
like...
read out your number.
That making the call thing is actually smart because it's like, I don't want to have to do this. I've done it once and I was like, yeah, could I please get the overs on like... They're like, sure, tell me your full name. I'm like, do I have to? Fuck.
Did you ever have... were you ever as a young kid before online betting... around perhaps a household where there was a mad punter who had the phone and they'd call and they'd shout the number. You shout your number straight away to the TAB lady, like old Dot on the panel.
We'd go
1 2 6 8 9 3 2 4 got one here on fucking Mackay off the gate, please.
We'd go up to the tab.
Right.
Dude, I haven't been into a tab for a while.
Yeah.
My dad used to take me to the tab every once in a while.
Yeah.
I was living.
I tell you what, the tab, the actual tab where you can't drink is an interesting joint.
Yeah.
I reckon they should bring back the bricks and mortar.
There's a couple still around.
They're still around. Yeah. You don't see
them. Is there one in
the
junction?
See, the
oh!
Yeah, there's a couple around. You see them in country towns. But the yarn is, in UK, all the different fucking bookies have a shop.
Yeah, Ladbrokes have one. Like,
yeah, so in this Pinnacle. World, in Neds would have their own shopfront.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah.
So there, and is, I mean, I just feel like from vibe and vibe alone that, like, it's an old man's game. The fucking the bricks and mortar tab. Yeah. Like, I feel like you said that's gonna the interest in that's gonna die out, right? Sure.
It becomes like, I guess not dissimilar to the man who will sit on his phone as like a means to relax with the betting app open. But it's like, I'm going to just go and do that, but with all the screens in front of me.
Yeah.
A little bit of trackside as well.
Yeah. Dude,
just
for fun. Right.
Listen, I on some level, I sort of get it. It's 10 o'clock. You don't want to get on the piss. You want to get out of the house.
You thought,
I'll wander up and put a couple on, you know,
well,
the
trots
in New
business.
Zealand.
Yeah, it's business, though. You've been given the tips.
No.
Thanks, mate. I'm not going to go to the pub and forget about
okay,
it.
Oh, okay, for now.
It's
thank
like,
you, bro.
I'll just get, I've got the tips. Let's go do it. Main street of town.
Yeah.
Missus is doing something else. Or you spend a day there.
If you were, because you can't, like, it's not a place I think the TAB you'd like to go drunk. But, like, it is somewhere I wouldn't mind going a little stoned. And if I'm sitting there by myself reading the paper
all
day.
You'd be reading the paper. You'd be putting
You're just hanging out. A couple of old blokes in there that you're talking shit with.
Yeah. Numbers falling around you. Just
that's it. It's like it's like you're in the Matrix, but for just like dribblers.
But I also think if you're going to go up there and read the paper and try to get a read of things, you wouldn't be going every race. That's pub stuff.
Yeah.
You're picking your moment to sort of...
Oh, but they spend all day there. Like, it's...
Yeah, but...
I wonder if they're just looking at... It's literally looking at form, right?
Well, that's what I mean. You're studying the form. Yeah. How's the track racing?
Yeah, these guys are geniuses.
Nick Meaney.
Ezra. Go. Find Adam Reynolds. Find Adam Reynolds for me. Chase him down, and then we find
like
Adam Reynolds.
Year here, what?
Oh, that was interesting. That's not bad.
Are they were waiting for a whistle or something? What was...
Just an intercept.
Like no, I think really... I think he was just looking for support because he was caught.
Reynolds, straighten up.
Interesting game. This has been end to end.
Yeah, it has. Oh! Dean Mariner.
Bang,
needed him.
I thought you took him out.
No, I've got him in my bet. I just added him to my bet.
Oh, that's right.
So we got a couple of bets going, guys.
Who's your first try scorer? Didn't you take Dean out today?
No, I had Dean as my first try scorer, then I switched it to Adam Reynolds. So obviously I am upset about that. But
that's what I'm talking about.
That does upset me
that's
a little bit.
That's what I'm talking about.
Just trying to not show too much emotion. Was that a knock on there? No, surely not. Yeah, well, it can't be. They let the play go on.
Oh, so what do you can't go back and look?
Not after the tackles made.
Right, okay.
Manly got a fortuitous try in the 2011 grand final from a similar situation.
In the red leather days. I was speaking about the red leather couch days with Mason Horror this week.
Oh, the red leather couch.
Yeah.
That thing was a sticky old beast.
About the red leather
I don't get leather
couches.
That's
when you moved to first grade at Manly, you got to go to a kick-on with the red leather couch.
Yeah. Dude, those kick-ons sound like particularly fucking...
Welcome to first grade, son.
Oh, yeah. There's some yarns.
I got to be honest. Like, remember we had it at Redfern as well, that leather couch. Well, you do... Actually, maybe the leather couch had gone by the time you got there. Mm. But, like... And no disrespect to all of you proud owners of leather couches out there, but I don't get it. It works in winter, but it's not a trans-seasonal option, right?
It's for the good room that you don't go in,
yeah, but
right?
If it's over fucking 15 degrees, you stick to that thing and you sweat wherever your body is touching it.
There's nothing comfortable about leather.
No. And that's a very... And we... Fuck, if you've fallen asleep on one in summer all day...
Dude, you have to get peeled off.
You get a fucking spatula.
That's where I got fucking shingles was down there, that leather couch.
I mean, that's the reason, yes.
Apparently, Buzz Rothfield had shingles recently. We hope he's doing well. But just to give you an idea of the type of... like. So, people of Buzz's ilk are the people that should get shingles, not
shingles
a 22-year-old me.
The cause of shingles is lack of exercise, lack of vegetables,
sunlight.
Lack of sunlight.
Yeah. Well, there were no windows down there.
So you've got old men and bong lords in that Venn diagram.
Yeah, and people living underground.
There was a summer of bacon.
Yeah, no, I know. Yeah, well, you know when the summer of bacon began? Like when he
what
first...
What a summer it was.
When he first started to slip into that sort of world, I suppose, much like, your first drink is the catalyst for an alcoholic.
Yeah.
We went into Woolies once, and Burmo was always a rindless operator.
Yeah.
No rind, please. Mm. Didn't
I was
read
on rindless.
Oh, right.
And we were like, why are you so about this rindless life? It was obviously reared on it, right? We're like, fuck that. It's more expensive. We're going to get the big 1.5 kilo black and gold, Woolies label.
Half of it's white.
Half of it's white. Exactly right. And we're going to fry this bitch up. Tom was like a kid in a candy store. When he first touched that cooked rind, it was game, set, match.
Floppy,
and so I wasn't that surprised to learn that a year later he developed a rind addiction.
Yeah, dude. It's like gateway. Like, you got me into it.
The summer of bacon.
And
this hat started hurting when I was hearing all that shit.
Yeah.
But that coupled with the fact there was no windows down there.
No, there wasn't.
No windows. And no
the walls would, the walls would actually start to, like,
drip.
Sweat. They'd
dehumidifier shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good stuff.
Oh, they would actually
no,
sweat.
Like, as in, you could, like, if you were thirsty, you could lick the walls. I didn't, just
sick.
So you know, I didn't do it.
I cannot figure out for the life of me what that room would have been used for, not some dude sleeping in there getting shingles. Like, I can't, there was no...
Because
I can't imagine, I just don't imagine old fucking Redfern would have had a cellar back in there.
Any windows?
No windows, dude. I reckon
maybe
it could have been
a bit of glass brick action?
No. Or maybe glass brick in the
glass
in the
bricks
couch
probably
room.
On the fucking, on oh, the floor, right on the very top of the... So you're getting like...
But the bedroom itself was windowless completely.
Yeah.
Which is illegal. You can't sell that as a bedroom.
No, I was paying. I was paying. Now, listen... In fairness to the landlord at the time, whether they were selling it as a room or whether the people we were living with were just subletting it as a room, looking at an extra, bit of cashish coming in.
How long were you down there?
Mate, not that long, to be honest, because the guy upstairs moved and I was like, get me out of here. Like that old lady in Happy Gilmore, like hanging on the front of the car, get me out of here.
Who moved in there after you, anyone?
Yeah, someone.
Like, was it in
T-Mate? T-Mate. No, it was T-Mate. No, Hamish was before me.
Hamish was up the top, right up the top. Mm. Yeah.
And then you left.
Then I left
the front room and I moved in.
I think I gave you my bed.
And I've still got paintings that you had.
Really?
The cowboy one. It's at my.
I have no recollection.
It's now with me in Batuta. So
good, dude. That's nice. So yours.
Is this Little Everly?
Yeah.
The all or nothing days.
Seriously. It's like, I mean, I think it's
actually,
funny.
I drove past your old joint tonight and it looks like a very similar operation.
Oh, were you in Little Everly?
No. I was on the corner of Redfern Street and Regent Street. Above the Manchester
building.
Shop.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
And I could hear a Brazilian cunt on the phone yelling to someone as we drove past. I said, I don't think the situation's changed.
Oh, mate, that was that was a wild time.
Yeah, they were interesting times.
I was living there when the Rabbitohs won in 2014.
So was I.
Yeah.
And so we got the train home from the game and the street was shut down. But it was just
Bedlam.
Like my street was shut down. So I was like, all of my friends, we could just go upstairs, get pissed, come back down.
Yeah.
Didn't you say you woke up to the bus?
when they had the celebration
parade
team bus. And it was going from, I think, Redfern Oval, or maybe South Juniors.
Yeah.
This is like a few days later or whatever.
When they're all wearing sunnies and shit and they're all busking.
Yeah, and it was going up to Town Hall, I think, I don't know. But the bus stopped at the lights at my window. And I was like, dead shit, 20-something, and just like looked out the window and made eyes with the Burgess brothers.
Try time. Guitar up. Absolute specimen.
Isn't it crazy to think that there's still one from that fucking era?
Yeah,
well, we'd had a bit of a history, me and the Burgess brothers.
So. Oh, really? There's only room for fucking, you know, one big fella in the room sort of thing.
Bit of like who really fucking runs the streets of Redford, you know?
And I think it was more, you're not welcome at this kick-on anymore.
Look, I don't want to get into it.
He's got a song. Have you heard his song?
No.
You're not welcome at this kick-on anymore.
Oh, really?
I'm sorry for bringing that up. It's funny. It's fine.
I'm a composer.
Wait, can you sing it for us right now?
You guys got a guitar? Oh, I actually brought one.
Oh, great.
Yeah,
well, give us some context.
Well, it got basically, I ended up back at a party with one or more of the Burgesses. Things got a bit out of hand because of me.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And
so you were escalating.
Well, I was facilitating and trying to make sure everyone's having a nice time. And, you know, and then I kind of like left because I was like, I can't contain this fire anymore, you know. It's like if the RFS ran away when the fire got out of hand, that's what I was doing. And
what and have I done?
I saw one of them at Casablanca. Not too long after.
Casablanca.
The club. Love a sax.
Yeah. It was, I was in line to go to the toilet, which in itself is just like, that's enough for me not to go back to the East for a few years.
Seriously.
But
lining up for a piss.
And one of the Burgess boys in front of me in line, he just turned around and looked at me and goes, oh, no, lad. And like walked off. And then, you know, a little while later, they win the grand final. The bus pulls up and I'm just looking at him out of my first floor window. He's like,
they really had the keys, didn't they?
Yeah.
Power I might take this hat off, actually. I don't want to disrespect anyone further. And
well, I might have fallen. You might have already
disrespected. That's the thing. It's like,
kind of an heirloom, too. So, like, yeah. You know, you don't want to lose the...
You've given it a run.
Yeah, I gave it a run.
That was nice.
Win a Manly back on. Broncos mode activated.
Heirloom.
Was it? Is that been
how many generations?
Yeah, if Dave got it for the storm.
Do you reckon there's two gens Melbourne Storm yet?
No. It came out. They came in 98.
Nah, I'm just wondering.
Dude, Dave was, Dave was born after like. The fucking... Like, when would Dave
what's
have been born?
What's the timing on a gen? What's the...
Well, actually, that's
25 years.
Okay,
25
so
years a gen? Can we
but
get that
I think
up?
Maybe
so, he's... Put it this way. His bar mitzvah was 2011, which means he was 13.
Man, they're on the come that year. Not a big deal.
So what would that make him? Was he alive after they were founded? Surely.
Yeah. No, he was... He was born in 98? So that was the year they came in.
Yeah.
Okay.
And they won it in 99. Was that grand final?
Okay, so it would require him to have a kid by now to be second generation.
Yeah, get to work, Dave. Yeah, if you're
Dave, what the fuck are you doing? Thought about getting Dave on for a stream one time, but I almost don't know if I'll be able to handle it.
Yeah, the I mean, all of these things are dribbly, right? And
oh,
he's
yeah.
not even here.
Dude, like, he had what was the
and the struck off scarf?
What was the book he used to have on the
so
bench?
So dumb.
What was the book he had? The Communist Manifesto.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And he had a Storm Babushka doll. Fucking dribbler.
Make no mistake, Dave is one of always tripped. Dave is one of the biggest dribblers known to man.
But it's also, the Storm needs people like that in the open.
Oh, absolutely. You know no, you're mean? Right.
Like, who's that guy from the Roosters that used to have the chicken hat? And then there was the skinhead from St. George, the skull they called him.
Oh,
was literally
yeah,
Nazi.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, they've all got these different people.
Well, I don't, yeah, they're probably not looking for that.
I know. But you need people out there who are just absolutely tragic.
Yeah, that will get banned eventually.
Yeah. Molly Meldrum. Borderline, they reckon.
Yeah, no, Molly Meldrum was.
Oh,
wow,
that was
dude.
Big.
That was fucking AFL City there.
Yeah.
Is he held up?
No way. If he got held up, that is insanity.
Are we at Suncorp or Melbourne Rectangular
Stadium? No, he's on the ground. That's
Melbourne
a try.
Rec.
That's
Melbourne
a try. Rec.
MRS.
That was huge, dude.
MRS.
Have you been to the MRS?
No, I haven't, but I love that they can't. You know, like
the
Lane
ABC
Park.
You can't call it Amy.
Well, it's just not named after anything. So, like,
well, and you can't call it a park because it's the wrong shape.
Yeah. So,
wait, this is Amy Park, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Amy Park, but that's its sponsor name. Its actual name, because they didn't have any league legends when they founded the Storm. They just called it Melbourne Rectangular Stadium. That's its real name. So the ABC have to call it that. And then during the Matildas, they can't say Amy. So it was like, the Matildas are playing at Melbourne Rectangular Stadium.
Like, yeah. Jesus, you'd think if they got a few legends they could fucking name it after now. Like, yeah. They've got, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Well, Lazarus Stadium.
Just call it Lazarus.
Just call it Lazarus.
I mean, that's
yeah.
pretty sick.
Yeah,
that is. Lazarus is mad.
It's a, what a, like, listen, Glenn Lazarus doesn't get enough love for his last name.
No, he really doesn't. And, like, it's almost because his footy career was so good, it's actually outshone his fucking name.
Yeah.
Whereas, like, you know, you could also see a 45 game with the last name Lazarus, and that's what he was remembered for.
Yeah.
He had quite a run. And I also heard a funny yarn from old mate Grantley. You met Grantley before?
Grantley?
Yeah, Grantley Crichton. He
does he get Grant?
He drinks up at the rails. I thought you might have met him over the years. One of those young lads, one of those older blokes.
He's Grantley, the big unit.
Yeah, Grantley. His mates with Cyril Mundine and all the Mundines. And he told me, and this is probably fucking hot property right now.
Yeah.
He said back in the day.
We are live.
Lazarus had a Koori Misses, and all of the in-laws used to bully him into playing the knockout back in the 80s, which was just so funny. Lazarus, we all know the truth, but you're being bullied.
Oh, that's awesome. And he went, didn't he? Yeah.
Of course.
What are you going to do?
you play.
What are you going to do?
You play. You're playing for the Raiders.
You play in the knockout,
you're in New South Wales, technically.
You play.
You didn't make the grand final. You're playing the knockout.
You're playing the knockout. Fucking oath. Yeah, Glenn Lazarus.
That is
Glenn Lazarus
ridiculous.
Oval.
Lazarus.
I just like Lazarus.
No. But I like.
You don't even need to put an oval.
I also like. I like when they call it an oval and it's not like Brookie. Like that's or is that an oval?
It's called Brookvale Oval.
I think it's an oval.
Is it an oval?
I think because the shape of it
used to be an oval
is ovular.
Is it ovular?
Am I saying that right?
No, I think so. Yeah. Uvula.
Uvula.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Because Suncorp Lang Park from above is an oval.
But it's a park.
I'd say Brookie started as an oval that built out, right?
Yeah.
To the point where they're like, we've got to put rectangular fences in.
If it's called Brookvale Oval, it stands to reason that it
started as well.
Yeah, like North Sydney Oval.
Yeah. Its origins were in
Coogee Oval, another great oval.
Yeah, one of the great ovals.
Yeah.
One of the great ovals.
Good hill at Coogee Oval.
But I like the idea of just calling it Lazarus.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Nothing else.
That's it. And you go to Lazarus. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I like that.
That's it.
Because you can't permanently give it a brand name.
But there's stadiums now. You're going to fuck around with like all the bullshit.
But listen, I think there'd be some who may say that he's not the biggest Melbourne legend. And so, you know, like,
we haven't even gotten that far
whilst
yet,
the like, name is good. Yeah, I know, but I'm walking.
What are you going to call it? Smith?
Yeah, well, Smithfield. No, you don't.
What about By Stadium?
Oh, look, Marcus Bye. Fucking Marcus Bye.
You're talking about another Storm legend.
Well, it is Melbourne.
Dave.
Yeah, Marcus Bye was actually a fucking animal. Tawira Nickow Oval.
Ooh,
Was he the one that lost a leg?
Yeah,
with
did.
The big mullet?
Yeah.
He was one of the early mullets.
Tawira Nickow was the preeminent mullet of rugby league, at least from my
this is pretty good stuff.
Wow.
That was a high try.
Yeah. Wow. I'm going to hate that I put Meany and Pappenhausen in my bet now, aren't I?
This is actually a sexy match.
It is a sexy match.
Yeah, it's a really good game.
This is sexy rugby league. Really enjoying it.
Tristan? Looking good.
Yeah, he is. These are teams that play rugby league. And I know that sounds like something a rugby league coach would say, which is like, I just wanted to go out there and play rugby league. Yeah. But like, these are teams that really do just play rugby league.
It was the dribbler hotline years ago in the pandemic. And he called in from Molong. And he said they didn't have enough blokes in town because all the industries had been sent home.
Mm.
They didn't have enough blokes in town to run the league and the union side. So they had to combine them into the league comp. All the remaining union guys. So
might have been Dowler.
So they had the Bulls.
And the Magpies.
Yeah, the Bulls and the Magpies. So they called them the Meat Pies. and the coach had to bring the two teams together, like remember the Titans.
Yeah.
He said, guys, we're not playing league, we're not playing union, we're playing fucking footy.
Yeah. And he's right.
At the end of the day, he's right.
You imagine they would have pumped him.
Just quickly as well, I forgot to do this, but we've actually got a hotline now, just so you know. You can call in or text us 0483 144 593. Questions, you know, quizzy questions. We got a lot of fucking rugby league quiz.
Oh, yeah.
But it's there. What do we got here? Just some stats that are coming through. No questions, yeah.
Text in your idea for Melbourne Rectangular Stadium.
Yeah, fuck yeah. What should we call that stadium?
Melbourne Rectangular.
MRS.
Yeah, MRS.
The MRS.
The MRS. Lazarus clearly in front.
Lazarus.
Yeah, Lazarus not head Smith, and shoulders like above. Not Slater.
Slater. Nah. The Bush poet.
Pappenhausen would cause journalists and fucking a lot of drama.
Yeah, ABC journalists.
Yes.
Is,
Poison Stadium.
As a proud Queenslander hitman, are you getting the ick off Billy Slater? Is he giving you the
ick? No.
In like his bush poetry sort of shit.
He gets up there and he's like, yeah, Queenslanders, floods and
he basically like, oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. You're like, this is a post-game press conference, Billy. What the fuck are you doing?
I got my guitar right here.
A coach of mine once told me.
Yeah.
Dude, you had one coach. We know who
it is. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Your coach was Craig Bellamy. Say his name.
Coach of mine once told me.
Coach of mine for many years. Yeah, Craig Bellamy.
Craig.
Yeah, we know him.
I think though Slats is imperative, right? Slater.
Slats.
Yeah. I'm not paying homage to
Michael.
Follow his him on Instagram at the moment.
We had a cigarette in the fucking fire exit at the SCG with
Michael
the other
Slater.
Slats, yeah.
Whose Instagram is very Robin Williams 1 hour photo at the moment.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Check that out. Yeah. Anyway.
Well, he challenged ScoMo to a debate.
Yeah.
Prank called him once.
You did?
Yeah. From we were at Splendor, and a mate of mine worked.
Someone had Slats' number at Splendor.
Yeah. Someone Frank had his number, and we're like, fuck, let's call him. I called him and said, Slats, it's your plumber. Your pads are stuck on the S-bend again.
Did he bite? Did he bite back?
Just hang up, hang up.
Your pads. Oh, God. Probably like 5 a.m. Yeah.
Daft Punk Alive 2007 pumping in the background. Didn't even go to the festival the whole time. Just stayed in the house.
Bro, that's so good.
That's so good.
Yes, man.
Ooh, was that your work?
Oh, that's man, it was so workshopped. Funny,
workshopped. Holy shit.
That's so funny,
That's
dude.
Almost the best thing I've ever heard.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, shout
that's
out
so
to that.
Funny, dude.
That's incredible.
To the boys.
Oh, my God.
No Triple A, mate. We were literally, we just stayed in the house the whole time.
Oh, yeah.
Splendor's a kilometre away. We're like,
touch the grass.
It's all good. We'll just sit in the car listening to music. And
Splendor in the Airbnb.
Oh, wow. Bruh.
Jesse.
The fucking Bronx are on.
Damn. They're here to play footy. Fucking hell.
Look at that hair. It's very Peaky Blinder-esque with the mo too.
Yeah,
Arthur.
Very Arthur. Very Arthur.
Yeah.
It's also, this is going to be a niche one, but it's very Billy Loomis from Scream 1. Sorry. Hamish Street would have got that.
Yeah, wrong crowd.
I think I remember it. Is that Courtney Cox's brother?
No, that's Dave Arquette. Billy Loomis was the killer. Sorry to spoil the film.
Liver alone. You know, liver gag?
Makes a liver joke, dude.
Yeah.
I think
come on, man.
I remember those films fucked me up.
I know they fucked me up as well. I actually don't watch scary movies at all
anymore. It turns out you watch it again and it's like a comedy.
Really? Is it?
It's so
just a horny
silly
teenage
and,
shit. Yeah.
But when you're 13, 14, it's terrifying.
Yeah.
Streams down, come back up, shout out to the rain. As long as they didn't miss that fucking pads in the S-Band yarn.
Yeah, did that get through?
That's Clip City, please.
Clip that up.
Fuck, I've got a few people that if that goes up, I'll send it over to and they'll be like, oh, fuck, you got it on there.
Yeah. Not Media Watch this time.
Yeah, fingers crossed.
Yeah.
God.
Mask off.
Dixie. Can I have some of that, bro?
Yeah.
Stream down, Devo.
Let us know we're back up.
I too have been taking part.
Oh, we're back up? Oh, we're good.
Back up.
Sorry for the stream going down. What are they?
Double happiness.
Oh, dude. No, that's right. We have some, we like to get into our work post-stream.
Yeah, that's fair. Good rule.
Streety the other night when he was on, he's like, dude, let me smoke in here. And I'm like, no. He's like, fucking let me smoke. And I'm like, Streety.
Well, like, you see those sprinklers there,
yeah,
bro?
They're going to turn on. And like
there's so much kid here.
Yeah, that's going to completely fucked. And it's actually like the only time you see dribblers who have gone like, yeah, Streety, nut. No. They usually be like, let him smoke, you fucking pussy. They're like, no, dude.
Let me smoke.
Has he got an AC/DC forearm tat there?
That would be
surely
that is,
not.
Again, like not his vintage. I'm impressed. There was 100% Nakadaka tat.
Are they still playing?
AC/DC.
Yeah.
Are they?
Yeah,
they
I thought because... that. Is it Brian Johnson, the frontman? I thought he was like fucked.
Yes,
I thought he was
In the non tattoo,
the skin left behind,
inversed, yeah,
hell yeah,
I respect that.
You're on the Arthur Shelby.
It'd be funny if he got the you know, that t-shirt that's the AC/DC logo, but it says ADHD. That'd be a big lifetime commitment,
yeah, I know. Especially when...
Look at the size of that
guy. Not landing.
He's like...
He went into a brewery the other day, the Four Pines Brewery, and the trough wasn't like a normal trough. It was almost like... It was like a literal trough, like up off the ground. And I was like, if you were 3 centimeters shorter than Eddie or I, like you couldn't piss in this thing. It was
like
D
or Dave's a huge shot.
D or Dave would have had to have like shot up and over.
Really?
Yeah. Like he was trying to scale
almost
a grappling hook.
He'd almost had a hard on to get...
Yeah, to get all strength required.
Yeah.
Yeah, stand on his mate's shoulders.
Sure. Like,
open the trench coat. Yeah. They just snuck into a movie.
Are we still down?
We're back up.
Yeah, right.
Back up.
Sweet, back up.
Sorry.
Do you notice the mullets are tapering?
We're going to keep going in and out, punters and dribblers. There's a bit of rain about. The rains are here, and we aren't in a...
You know the drill. We're not going to tell you a million times.
Yeah, our internet's fucked.
Oh, flat. That was a nice ball.
What do you mean the mullets are tapering?
They're tapering out a little. It was like a year ago, 2 years ago, everyone had one.
We were talking about this the other day, actually, Eddie, that the mullet, it's not as like...
Prevalent.
No, it's come and gone. It's come and
gone. Well, it's not gone, but it's certainly not like every player has one. Because that was what it was. Like, every single
Aussie rules, they're still banging around quite a bit.
Yeah, but they're late. They're late,
they're
to,
late
the
to the party Aussie generally, rule. Right?
Let's not pretend like AFL doesn't look to the NRL for what's trendy.
6'8" That guy is 205 centimeters.
That's big. That's freaky tall.
Would that be closer to 6'9" than 6'8"? Yeah. 6'8" is a bit.
And that's Takura.
But to be fair, you stop counting after 6'4", don't you, Archie?
What is it, mate? 6'4" or 6'5"? Doesn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Yeah. Makes no difference up here, mate. Although it actually makes heaps of difference. Yeah. Whenever I meet someone taller than me, I go, Jesus, fuck.
Anyone taller than me.
Yeah, you must wig out.
Yeah. But they're freaks when you see them. Like, they're taller than you're like.
Yeah, dude, that's how we see you two.
I know, but we see ourselves as just acceptable.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, just.
No, but you guys are
just able to fly economy.
Yeah, but
right?
But if you're a centimetre taller than me, you're fucking Wembanyama.
Yeah.
You're fucking...
He's...
You've been bred by the Chinese government to play basketball.
Dude, Wembanyama is actually fucking absurdly big, though. He's 7 foot, isn't he?
7'2",
maybe. 7'2". That's and, like, absurd. His arms are ridiculous.
Yeah, he's broken the game.
Oh, wow. We got a game on our hands.
Katoa
for two, not
he's
Nick Meaney.
He's a beast.
Harry Grant. He's actually a bit short, isn't he?
Yeah, but then you meet him. And again, you're tall, bro. But like, then you meet these people and you're like, oh, actually, like Mitch Pearce was in here the other day. And I'm like, you're actually not that small.
And there's a thickness to it, right?
Well, and a hardness.
Yeah.
But so the thickness and the hardness.
The one that always surprises me when you meet him, like Paul Gallen, not tall.
Yep.
Watmau, not tall, but you're just, they're thick.
Yeah. You can't help.
So thick.
There's a density.
Chomp's got that thing about him where you have to touch him, you know, like.
Yeah.
It's
also though when they touch you, like when if you get like a they get a bit pissed and you're like, fuck dude, like your grip strength is messed up.
Yeah.
Like you could bruise my arm by squeezing it.
Yeah. When they start to get physical, you sort of, you know, you edge away.
Yeah.
You know?
Gordon Tallis put a hit on me once as a joke, and I say hit because it felt like
But Gordy's huge.
He is huge, but it was literally like, you know, when you see like the 1-inch punch, you're like, oh. It was like a 1-inch punch of a shot, and I was like, get fuck, oh, boy, like it really hurt. Yeah.
We were in,
feel this. You're like, oh, fucking hell.
We were in, when we were in Las Vegas, we'd done the interview with Gordy that morning. Terrific, great bloke. And that night we were going in to see
Those daytime interviews were fucking top.
They were a lot of fun. Really, everyone was fucking hungover.
And the boys were so
hung. You could feel the buzz through it.
It was an exciting day.
And so we were like coming in to like stand with the boys, and the security's like, oh, who are you? What's your go? And then Gordy just spots us and walks over and goes, oi, they're with me. And it was just like, just said with such a tone. We're with Mr. Talis.
We're with Mr. Talis. Thank you.
I love that Gordy's, you see in all those fucking, you know, Sunday night, Thursday night shows, how they rip him about being like, now that he's very fancy. You know what I mean?
Dude,
like
what's funny is I didn't realize this either.
He takes them all to nice restaurants in Brisbane and then makes fun of them for ordering spag bowl at Gambaro's. It's like,
But he's always, you look back and he's been a bit like fashionista, not the right word, but at least like fashion aware. Like there's photos of him back, Ed Hardy
was big.
And he's wearing like Air Maxes and he's like different, like these, there was a period in our life growing up, and then maybe it's coming back now, but we're like real baggy cargo pants were in.
They are coming
and back. Gordy in baggy cargo pants with an Ed Hardy t-shirt. Again, you look at Ed Hardy and you go, how?
Yeah.
How did that happen?
And how did Gordy pull that off?
Pulled it off.
Because he was the Raging Bull, I guess. No one said shit.
No, you don't say shit, dude. You shut
Well, it's
the
for the
up.
Same reason that Secker was like, oh, he's with you guys, even though I don't know who you are. It's the aura.
Aura. You can feel it.
It's presence.
Yeah.
It's oozing out of his
and
pores.
And I guess security guards universally know that someone with that aura
taken out? Pappenhausen penalty try? No.
It's almost like he's got authority over all the other atoms around him. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like,
and someone like that, the bouncer trusts that they don't lose control.
Yeah.
So it's like, well, if who's actually in charge of the world says,
it's just Gordy's fucking Doctor Strange shooting
the corner. We're still on here, Tobler. Okay, fuck it. Let's just keep rolling. Who gives? We've got a trivia question here from Zach from Brisbane. Adjacent Seinfeld trivia. He thinks Eddie may know it.
Yep.
Which famous singer-entertainer passed away the night of the Seinfeld finale? Old. He would have been old. Very famous.
When was that?
What is that, 98?
Frank Sinatra?
Yes, dude. Oh. Fucking hell.
That's pretty good.
Wow. Go! How the fuck did you know?
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah,
it
that's
fits
a
in
huge
there.
Get.
Mate, we got a new Melbourne thing, eh? Oh, hold on.
What's wrong?
No, someone's saying something. I'm trying to...
Mate, I'm a big Seinfeld fan. I quite enjoy it. I used to... I come in and out with Seinfeld in the...
This is from a chick. She says, Mama likey.
It's onlyfans.com/DonJoyride for the leg cross. Yeah. For the adjust.
Sharon Stone.
Yeah.
I'm going to go have a...
A little wee-wee? Go for it.
So we're on and off, on and off.
Whatever. We're just going to keep rolling. We come on,
Now, can I tempt you boys with a Baileys?
I'd love one.
Fucking oath. Yeah,
I once drank Wallaby Bar out of their milk one night. I was drinking Baileys and milk the entire night. And I'm like, mate, we're out. It's got to stop. Stop the fight.
Oh, good.
So you love a Baileys.
I
do. Good.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. We are, like, I've always known Baileys is nice, right? Like, it's one of those things where it's like, you know, like, Baileys is never not nice.
Yeah.
But I have to come back from, on the way over to Vegas as well, but certainly on the way back, we fucking smashed Baileys. Then every stream since, I think we've got we've got well and truly stuck in.
I'm a big dairy guy generally.
I am, but I can't drink milk anymore.
You've gone.
My body's changed. It happens when you get to 30 something, right? Your body just starts going, oh, I can't do any. I can't process shit like I used to.
Yeah.
So now I have like a glass of milk, and I just am like my guts start fucking.
I feel
bubbling.
Like my I'm just not good enough at listening to my body to know that it's doing that.
See, I've only really started listening to my body like, and I'm like a sugar addict. I like chocolate, fucking whatever else, but like. I've only just realized now that, like, if I, and especially on something like Easter, where you're like, oh, there's just like chocolate literally everywhere.
Hall pass.
Like, it's fucking everywhere.
Yeah.
But then, like, there was a lint bunny in my house on the Monday after Easter. So technically, I should just have given up the fucking chocolate, but I find a lint bunny in the fucking cupboard and I go for
it. It's got to go. It goes now or, you know, yeah.
Forever hold your peace. Now, I got into half of it, and then I just noticed that, like, 20 minutes later, I'm like dozing off. I'm like this, and it can, like, you get a little spike of just being like, oh.
That was nice.
This is what crack is, right? Yeah. And then I'm just like, and I'm dozing off now. I'm like, I can't keep doing this.
Yeah, I'm exactly the same. I've been fucking like pilfering Easter eggs around the office at work because everyone's got these. They did like an Easter egg hunt.
Oh fuck yeah!
And so
Jesus, look at that beast.
Oh, thank you, bro. So everyone's got all these Easter eggs left. Like they couldn't just eat them in one sitting.
No,
which I would have.
Yeah, same.
And
I sometimes will tell myself as well, like I have to eat them in one sitting because otherwise, like. I'll eat them tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. They've got to go now.
Yeah.
I need them out of here now.
Even if I don't feel like anymore, I'm going to do it.
Yeah. I told my wife last night, she was like, those eggs up there for me, I want to like have them over the coming months. And I was like, no.
Incorrect.
No,
incorrect.
I'm going to have them right fucking now.
Yeah, there's no fucking way that's how it's going down.
You try and act like, oh, it's contained to Easter. But then, you know, I went to Woolies today and it's like, oh, well, now they're half price.
Yeah,
so
dude.
It's like, fuck.
I'm a sucker for a bargain, yeah. Dude. What idiot isn't doing this?
You want me to walk past that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Half price lint eggs?
A there's kilo of Easter eggs for $5? Fuck you, dude.
It's the shiny wrapper they're in. You know, I'm a sucker for that wrapper.
Well, those little ones are like...
They're
like
shiny, they're glittery.
They're dense, they're fuck. You know what I mean? Like,
you suck on the bitches.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And the fact you have to work for it, you know?
Oh, you got
to
work
for
it. You've
got to find the seam, try and flatten out the foil.
Because it doesn't actually, there are times where you'll get like a glory moment where you'll open it in like one, and you're like, wow, I haven't even ripped this thing.
Yeah.
Then there are times when you're almost like reminded of how pathetic you are because you have to take
foil specs.
Tiny bits of it trying to get it off.
I tell you when you know, and this has happened three times this year week, you know you've had Easter the previous weekend when I keep getting my clothes out of the dryer and there's just like Cadbury foil everywhere, right?
The little foil rocks in your back pocket.
Yeah, little foil rocks.
Foil
rocks, mate.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That's the sign of an Easter done well.
Yeah. Now,
it just is.
Well, wait for it. Did Archie's go punch a dart?
Yeah, he did.
That son of a bitch.
He did.
When he comes back, have we got
enough juice to trivia? Yep. Okay, we're okay.
We're running off dongles here, Joyride. So we can't fucking... For whatever reason, and I'm going to have, like, someone can correct me if I'm wrong, but this is what we were told when we moved in here. It's the owner of the building has basically, like, signed a deal with some Chinese internet provider, and so you can't even get... Firstly, we can't get NBN in here, and even if we could, you can only get this one type of fucking random Chinese internet. Everyone we've spoken to who lives in, like, the actual apartments upstairs is like, the internet is fucked here.
That's psycho.
So we are now, we're running like five dongles in this fucking joint. And we've got the first sight of rain, we're fucked. And which is just embarrassing for just such a professional operation.
For an online production company.
Yeah. It's really bush league. And then we've got, don't have the bolters in there. This is why. There's a four pack of bolters, so when the dongles overheat, we have to sit them on the beer and put them out there.
So we've got a Bailey's for you, mate.
We got your Bailey's, dude.
Which you'll need.
Yeah, you will. Now, we've got internet at this point.
Listen, in light of the internet situation, this will be a speed to market round. Speed to market.
And it's are they calling with the answer?
I think
because if it drops out, it's probably easy to call, is it not?
We can call. I mean, we can... Well, you know what? Speed to market.
All right, speed to market. Comment
because
section.
Because it's one of those ones you could look up whilst you're on the blower, so then it's just about calling
righto,
in first.
Righto.
What are we getting? What are we getting today, tonight? The seed?
They're going to get a white punters and dribblers hat. They're going to get a... Can they get a nut trucker, or are they gone?
How many we got left? Can we just get a stock take?
Stock take, here we go.
This is fucking delicious. Did you put... Chalky milk in this?
No, this Bailey's, is Bailey's, brother? Dude. You never had Bailey's?
You're I haven't get a, since I was stealing liquor from people's cameras.
Yeah.
No, but like, is that not the best thing you've ever fucking had in your life?
Yeah, dude.
It's smooth.
And, yes, and it'll get you where you want to go.
Yeah, it's smooth.
Mm-hmm.
Vanilla essence? Anything?
No, dude, no, no,
that's Bailey's at the price. This is, bro.
Here you go, dude. Doing all the heavy lifting.
Yeah, you know what? We're going to fucking send you a bottle on next Monday. Rock up to
yeah,
the...
Yeah, yeah,
and,
yeah, yeah.
And what are we talking milk-wise? Like a A2 protein milk?
We don't... No. That's straight out of the bottle, baby, with a block of ice. Thank you very much.
No milk.
No milk. You don't need milk.
Because you really don't need milk, right?
No, you don't.
No, you don't need milk.
It's an indulgence.
Like, delicious. I know you
drank Wally
you
bar.
Drank
out
the Wally bar out of milk, but you didn't need it.
I thought you put a splash in there.
No,
that's
dude. No.
It really holds up.
You just
right
need
itself.
A block of ice. Yeah. All right, so you're going to win a White Punters of Jubilees. You're going to win a Nut Trucker. You're going to win a Box of Good Day.
Six-pack. I said a six-pack or a bottle? We've already said it now, haven't you?
I said.
You said a six pack.
You said a box,
which is a six pack.
Fuck it.
Okay, there you go.
We're there.
Fucking oath. We're here
there.
Now.
It's sitting there.
There's plenty there.
That's sitting there. Also, if you want to play golf with me and Tom at Shorty's, you got to buy a box if you don't win tonight.
You got to buy Hellasport.shop.
That's it. Okay, this is speed round. Speed round. Got to be quick. Got to be quick. Got to be in it. Got to be in it now. As we know...
Still Titanic trivia?
Yeah, it is.
As we know, the Titanic does hit an iceberg, right? We all know that. That's the second half of the three-hour classic by James Cameron.
Second act.
Now, we would also know that Lovejoy, the right-hand man, the butler of Caledon Hartley, okay, Hockley rather, they put a diamond necklace in the pocket of Jack Dawson to frame him because Cal's fucking jealous of this guy who's just rooted his fiancée.
It's a class war.
Yeah.
It's a class war.
Can you not? Yeah. Is there not some sympathy for poor old Cal, though?
Well,
this
Cal's
little
just had
street
his
rat's just fucked his wife.
He got cucked.
I'd probably want to frame him, too.
He got cucked by a rascal.
Yeah, by a guy who was living under a bridge. This guy's like a billionaire.
You know what? It's like the modern day equivalent is the guy is like a bedroom rapper showing his demos to chicks on a fucking you know what I mean? It's like, check out these drawings I did of French chicks. It's like a tattoo artist. Look at this shit.
So obviously Cal in a fit of jealousy, they frame poor Jack Dawson.
Oh,
Jack.
Shit, just quickly, sorry. Adam Reynolds crying in the fucking sheds. It looks like he's injured again.
Ooh, he looks like he's out for the
season. Ah, shit, knee.
Can we get an update on that?
You just find some. We'll keep going. We'll come back to that.
So, Jack is locked up. The Master of Arms has taken him downstairs, and he's fucking banging on the pipes, and he needs help because the ship's sinking, water's rising. Now, Rose, realizing that her boy is innocent,
Her hobo.
Her street kid.
Yeah.
Street rat.
I won't cop that. Shout out to Aladdin.
She realizes the love's real, and she goes looking for him. Who does she come across? The ship's carpenter, okay? And she needs help. She needs assistance. And she says, where would the Master at Arms take someone who's under arrest, all right? Now, the answer given provides directions to find him. Mm-hmm. There is also a clue that she needs to go down a passageway. What's the name of the passageway?
Oh, shit. Okay. You're a dribbler, dude. I don't know how you fucking think of these every week. It's insane.
All I can say is this is the part of the film where you see the lower deck where the... Lebanese passengers, by the way.
They're Lebanese on the boat.
Third most common nationality on the Titanic after American and British.
Really?
French, Lebanese. They went through Cherbourg.
Oh, yeah.
But they're all doing the prayers.
Oh, was that Abruzio? And that may be the wrong name there.
Abruzio
was Italian. Okay, yeah. Forgive
Fabrizio
me.
Was Fabrizio was Italian.
But they're
I'm
doing
sorry.
The... remember
so
they're doing
sorry.
The prayers in the hallways when she's looking for him?
Yeah.
JC Rad.
JC Rad, well done, baby.
The Crewman's Passage.
Crewman's Passage.
JC Rad sounds Crewman's like
passage.
A rapper.
Crewman's Passage went from fucking end to end.
Is that also? Yeah. Oh, email turbo at hellosport.com.au.
End to end on the boat.
Yep. Quickly, though. Is that where he's like, but you've got to come this way, ma'am. And she punches him in the face. He's like, well, screw you.
Yeah, well, that was during that scene. I don't think that – she wasn't at the crewman's passage because she's gone down. She's found Jack, and Jack's like, get the fucking key. It's a little brass one, Rose. It's a little brass one. Yeah. Can't
he says
find
Rose
it.
Too much in that
well,
fucking scene.
It's my yeah, own, yeah, yeah. It's my only – it's the shortcoming of the film is that, is that they call each other Rose and Jack 50,000 times.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
like, it's too listen, you just got shagged in the back of a fucking car. Yeah. You're leaving your billionaire fiancé with this bloke. Stop calling him Jack.
Yeah, yeah. Better call him Babe.
Also, there's a slap.
Babe. Hey, Babe.
Hey, yeah. Keys over there, Babe.
Little brass one, Babe.
that would have fucked the movie up.
I always thought that the great twist of Titanic is that the initial setup is that Jack and Fabrizio, you feel like those two are going to get going.
Yeah.
Like, there's a bond there.
Yeah, you're yeah, right. Yeah. No, you're right. That would have been a nice
bond. Yeah, there's a bond. Yeah, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Rhinestone Cowboy-esque. Like, no, Midnight Cowboy.
Midnight like Cowboy?
Brokeback Mountain kind of mates.
Yeah.
As in they fuck each other.
Yeah, and they travel the world in the lower deck. You
yeah,
know?
there's a big vibe with those two. They're getting on.
Yeah, they probably are as well.
Well, they're good mates.
I'd like to see the Fabrizio story there. How's yeah, so he feel I. about Rose?
Yeah. I know. Yes. And they just get him, he just gets flattened
well,
by
he
that
gets
pole.
He gets yeah, no, yeah. Well, by a funnel.
Sorry, funnel. You know but, what I mean?
Yeah. And his mate Tommy's just been shot. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Chaos on board the Titanic. Yeah.
Chaos. You'd think they'd be able to keep it together.
In this moment of pure human hysteria.
Is the guy, the comedian who's on, is he on the Diamantina Network, Damien Power or whatever?
Yeah,
and he's
yeah,
like,
yeah.
His whole joke about like, with the Wim Hof method, like for a second when everyone, they were actually healthier for a moment.
She's his
wife, yeah. right?
Take no shit from no one.
Yeah, so she sympathises with Jack and finds him a suit, remember, when he has to go on the upper deck. Yeah.
She gives Jack her sons, and they're about the same size.
Yeah, exactly. Fits you perfectly, son. Kathy Bates.
yeah. It's
Reynolds out.
Waterboy's mum.
Reynolds won't return due to knee injury. He's crying in the sheds, which would imply to me weeks.
Straight back down. Bobby Boucher's mum.
Yeah.
Fucking oath. She was. That was almost my first. Then it was like, oh, she's like an Oscar-winning actress. I'm like, Bobby Boucher's mum?
Yeah. And it's like, oh, hang on. Adam Sandler has Paul.
Yeah, dude.
Did you see the guy, you will not make this putt? You jackass.
Yeah.
That guy died this week.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Did he really?
Yeah. Oh, no. I thought it was the actual celebrity chef or the celebrity. That
Bob Barker.
Oh,
Bob's
Barker
dead. Died
no,
not long
Bob
ago.
Died. No, that was Chubbs. Chubbs died last year.
Chubbs died February.
Oh, yeah. This year?
Yeah.
Chubbs died too.
And yeah, Chubbs is.
So there's a podcast I really like called Chasing Scratch. Two guys, American guys.
Sebo loves that as well.
Yeah,
shock
yeah. And they're really funny. They're good to listen to. They have a running joke about
the curse of Abby Gilmore.
Carl Weathers is the actor's name.
Yeah.
And they, after seven seasons, got him on the podcast and interviewed
him. Oh, really?
Really?
He died 2 days later.
No way! Really? So was it out of the blue, his death?
Yeah.
Must have been, right?
And so they put up the pod and then took it down out of respect for him and his family, spoke to his family, put it back up. And it is the most stirring listen.
Oh, really?
He, like, gives this, like, hype-up speech at the end. It's almost like he's eulogizing himself.
Right. Really?
Yeah.
Can you send me that?
Yeah,
I need to listen to that.
That's mad.
That's a must listen.
I'm like, well, I would... I guess I can understand taking it down, but it's like it's kind of like nice.
Well, yeah, but I think you want to clear
out.
That.
I guess 2 days before he dies. Yeah, that's probably true.
I think you want to clear.
Wait, here's a clip. Let's not clip this up and put it on Instagram.
But like this piano music starts, and they're like, "Do you have any advice for us?" And he goes, "Yeah, showing up isn't enough. What are you going to do once you get there?"
Oh, it's like doing this
fucking rev up, and it's like I got goosebumps now thinking about it.
Oh man,
you got to have a listen.
Also, remember just like that he could sing? We've only just begun to live.
Got my hand back.
What do these Chasing Scratch guys say about the impact that Happy Gilmore had on golf? Do they talk about that? Because I think it would have been monumental.
I don't know if they've really...
I wonder if it's had an impact on golf now. You know, golf's become like degenerate, fun, not tight, you know, top button done up.
Because that was ahead of its time, like, the idea of the bad boy
that's
in golf.
Like, that was the golf that you were, like, that I was introduced to. My old man would watch golf and I'm like, this is so fucking boring, dude.
Yeah.
And I now like conventional golf. Like, I can appreciate it because I realize how fucking hard golf is. But I, like, people of our generation seem to also really like, you know, a rip and a tear on a golf course.
Yeah.
Which has never been a thing.
Adelaide LIV kind of like,
woo!
Yeah, and you'd say, Happy Gilmore, I think, definitely is so culturally important that it's just like made a whole generation go.
Oh, for sure.
It was one of the best movies growing up, right? Oh, well done.
Yeah.
Like, it was one of the best movies.
Yeah.
Are you a Happy Gilmore or a...
Don't make me choose.
Billy Madison.
Billy Madison, yeah.
Out of the early era of Adam Sandler, I might go Wedding Singer.
Yeah.
Wow. I like Wedding Singer.
User.
Yeah. I probably would go...
Buscemi's best man speech.
Buscemi.
Fucking God tier.
That is terrific. Remember that time we went to Mexico?
I mean, I thought they were hookers, but I don't remember paying.
That's very good.
It's like Buscemi, another like acclaimed actor.
Yeah, just
that
fucking
is just
around
in every Sandler movie. Yeah.
Are they fucking like buds growing up? Or
They're in
a little bit of New York.
Airheads or whatever.
Airheads and Brendan Fraser and shit.
But Buscemi has a habit of just sworn in. Like, I reckon he caught the first or second season of Sopranos and was there time and was working as a fiery in New York on Manhattan. And no one ever gave him a time of day, and he never fucking piped up until the first Christmas party. After a year working as a fire, he stood on the top of the truck and impersonated everyone in the fire station perfectly. Like, and what about old mate over here? Where's my coffee? La, 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 la. And it was like, you know, you imagine these old fireys in the 90s.
That's shady, dude.
The one that we were watching Billy Madison in Vegas.
We were watching Billy Madison in Vegas.
And loving it. Yeah, this is like a
fucking...
Where you wake up
soothing.
At 6 o'clock at night and you're like, oh, Billy Madison's on. Let's not go out yet.
Yeah.
And
you too? They can what?
Yeah, it was... And that when he's Billy like goes back to apologize to people he bullied at school or some shit, and then Steve Buscemi goes and like puts lipstick on and then just shrubs Billy, scrubs Billy Madison's name out of his kill list.
Is it like the cars starts by "You're not the one"? What's the song on
and,
that?
And then at the end, but then at the end
the
when
lipstick, they made him so perverted.
at the very end of the film when he comes, there's a guy like about to shoot Billy Madison, and then Buscemi comes in and shoots the guy, and then Billy Madison goes, "Thank God I called that guy."
He just waves and fucks off. I started this thinking it was I was definitely Happy Gilmore, but I think
Billy Madison's pretty funny, it's kind of
absurd. I feel like Happy Gilmore still is best. It's my favorite. But, like, honestly,
there's something absolutely absurd about Billy Madison.
Yeah.
O'Doyle rules, they just drive off the fucking
Redknapp
cliff.
Family,
O'Doyle rules.
Like, the fact that, for whatever reason, they include this in the plot, that there's an O'Doyle in every year, like, that is so funny.
Well, no, it goes through the whole thing. And then there's, like, the carload of Doyles. And they hit
a
banana.
Farley's banana.
Chris Farley was fucking great.
That might have been one of his last arrives.
That is correct.
That might have been one of his last hurrahs, too.
That is correct. He's like...
Virgin,
it's
right?
Like a saying.
Yeah.
That's carried on.
But there's something about Adam Sandler, like... He obviously came in doing all those funny movies. He actually is fucking awesome in serious roles.
Yeah,
that
man.
Uncut Gems was crazy. But there are ones where, like, they're comedy movies. I saw one the other day where I'm like, oh, yeah, I forgot about that movie. You remember Bulletproof with one of the Wayans brothers?
No, was it?
The
it was,
gun in the ass.
Yeah. Martin Lawrence?
No, it was Wayne. It was a Wayne. I reckon you're thinking of Blue, something.
Thin Blue Line.
Martin Lawrence, and it was Owen Wilson's brother. Blue Streak.
Blue Streak.
That may not be what you're thinking of. That's what I'm thinking of.
It might be.
But no, I don't.
And he gets
they hide the diamond in the fucking thinger. That
but
movie.
Adam Sandler's climbing out of the hotel window and he puts the gun up the ass. That was the one, right? When they're staying in the hotel. Don't know why.
That's Bulletproof? Yeah, that's bulletproof. Yeah, that's bulletproof.
Yes.
Is that the Disneyland? Like,
That's bulletproof. Yeah.
That's it. You know,
even that movie's comedy and serious. Like, it's not Happy Gilmore level of stupidity or Billy Madison level of stupidity. And you can just see like
shot in bulletproof. From memory, like,
oh, but man, even the proper rom-com era, like 50 First Dates,
Like that, dude, Big Daddy, Big Daddy, mate, like that was emotional as shit. Yeah. I wipe my own ass, I know you do, buddy. Starts crying, I'm like, fucking hell, click,
Mr. Deeds,
click, Mr. Deeds was great. Buscemi in that movie, his eyes are all over the fucking joint.
I mean, I think Waterboy, like, needs
mate,
to,
mate, Waterboy, I'm just looking it up.
He didn't miss for a while, did he?
Up until February 2023, this article, $2.4 billion in grossing.
No way. Films.
Yeah.
Look, but even the ones, like even when we were like, oh, he's mailing it in, he was still doing the right thing. Like the yarn is that he would choose these films, which inevitably are filmed in Hawaii, and every one of the boys are on the cast.
No, that's smart. Just like, that's eyes
up. We've all got respect for that. We don't give a shit about how crap the film is. We just know you guys
spend
none
of them. But they still made money.
Yeah.
Even when they were like Jack and Jill and shit made money.
Don't mess with the Sohan. I mean? You're like, fuck, he's really not happy.
Sohan's pretty bad.
Sohan's pretty fucking like, okay. Like
the astronaut one that came out really
recently. I heard someone.
Little Nicky.
Oh, no, Little Nicky was mad. Little Nicky was mad.
Apparently it's pretty weird. That,
I
like,
loved
space,
it.
Space.
No, there's new space one.
Space Nuts. Man.
Oh, is it good?
With the talking spider.
Yes.
Yeah. It's. I loved it.
Oh, really? Who was telling us it was
Harry?
Weird?
But I'm in my.
He's a Whovian, by the way. Yeah. Dixie's a Whovian.
What's a Whovian?
I like Doctor Who.
Like a proper Doctor.
I don't even know. I've
Is that right?
Yeah.
But
Doctor
I also
Who.
Like
when you said Whovian, I immediately thought of the Grinch. I was like, what?
Yeah, who's in Whoville?
Phase where I call movies films.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you're a composer.
I'm a composer.
Well, I think there is a difference, and I'll give you the difference. Godfather 1 and 2 are incredible films. Godfather 3 is a great movie.
Okay, right. See, that's I actually have never seen a Godfather.
Haven't you?
No, I've seen bits and pieces of all of them.
Thomas, come on, mate.
I get it, dude.
You're better than that.
But I've seen at least 3 Fast and Furiouses, if that helps.
Depends which ones.
Well, they're the Godfathers of our time.
What's the one where Ludacris ends up in space?
That'll be later in the season.
Yeah, fucking hope that'll be later.
That's when I started hitting 9.
9, Willie. Number 6 was when they start going Black Ops. Number 5.
Well, it's like when it stopped being street racing and it started
being
DVD
theft. And then we're stealing a bank.
DVD theft. Yeah, this car's driving out of the back of a plane.
Yeah,
I like how they ramped it up.
Yeah,
so do
sure.
I.
Yeah,
well,
so
you got
kept all the cast and brought some back that were killed and just did not follow a linear fucking timeline.
Yeah,
no, like, that's like daytime TV sort of shit where you're like, I'm back. You're like, why? And you're like, well, fucking shut up. You're just gonna accept it.
There was a funny video I saw on TikTok or something semi-recently where someone goes through how ridiculous the names of the films are. Like, they don't line up. No. It's like these are in there and then these are dropped. Yeah. Like, I'll read them out. It doesn't make any... It
as
makes
in, like, the numbers like, of them? Like, or like
the naming of the movies is so, absolutely...
Oh, whoa!
Ezra.
Did they pull that back? Fuck, that was hectic. Tell me they don't pull that back. That was badass. Dude, Ezra Mam is a fucking footballer.
He can play.
Kid can play.
A lot of moustaches getting around the Bronx.
You reckon it's a no shave till finals situation?
Moustaches are only play on if you've got a strong jawline, you know what I mean?
I'm a
beard guy until my jaws are sizer starts kicking in. You know?
Stripping away.
Dude, that's nice. That's really hot rugby league. You know when you watch footy and like there's people that retire like greats and you go and even though you know that rugby league has never suffered from a lack of talent, you're like, fuck, I wonder who's gonna like come through. And then you just see these players like Ezra Mam come through and you're like, oh, he's now just like a big dick swinger in the NRL.
Especially in transitional moments where like 2-3 years ago we're like, how can anyone ever compete with what the Panthers have got going on now with that young
footy. Or it was the
footy.
Storm before the Panthers. Yeah. The Storm before the Panthers.
And then someone
and then,
comes in.
Then the Panthers come along and then you've got Reece Walsh and fucking Ezra Mam. You're like, Jesus.
Well, you just see dynasties pop up in the space of 18 months. Like, that's what the Broncos have done.
Exactly,
it wasn't long ago they were playing pokies in Harpoon Harry's.
And coming last.
Yeah. Remember that? That was tragic.
And then, well, I mean, it's all, it's like
And
Reynolds,
then we took
right?
your coach.
Milford.
It's, Reynolds has just kind of turned him into, he was a great
like a link acquisition. Man. Like, yeah, he's been able like, to bring
I'll,
him on.
I'll show you guys what
professionalism
hard
looks like.
Yeah. Footy is. And to the, you know, much to the detriment of the fucking Rabbitohs.
So dumb.
Well, it's just, the worst. It's been one of the great fuck yous of all time.
Do you reckon, yeah, it was the Rabbitohs trying to get on top of their emotions? Like, because they struggle emotionally when they have, like, all of these favourites.
No,
like,
I think it was them trying to be smarter than the room.
Sutton was an example of someone they could have sold off. Lots of love, Suts, you know, whatever, but played to the very end when he was broken and they couldn't get rid of him because he was so emotionally and part of the team.
At some point,
But I mean, with Adam Reynolds, right, like, good sevens are fucking rare as shit, right? Start there. But they get rid of him because they go, well, we don't sign people over the age of 30 beyond one-year deals.
Yeah.
Cody Walker signed, who was like 33 at the time, signed like a four-year deal. So that's complete bullshit.
Yeah, yeah.
So how old's Walker now?
He'd be about 33, 34. But yeah, I know, like, but he was over 30 when he was
signed. Everyone forgets that because he played his first Origin at 29.
Yeah. 34.
Yeah. And it's just like, well, this guy's played for the Rabbitohs his whole fucking life.
He's the heart and soul of the club.
He's the heart and soul of the club. And you're just going to go and
grew up on Pitt
like,
Street.
You're literally a community club. Like the Rabbitohs are the community club, right?
Yeah.
And they're just like,
unlike
one
year.
But to roll that excuse out, oh, we don't sign 30-year-olds beyond 1 year, and then sign Cody, who was beyond 30 at the time for a 3 or 4 year deal.
Mm. It's got a sting.
It would have to sting. And it was a fucking spit in his face because basically they're implying he's dumb. Goes up, takes him to the grand final. Yeah. They should have won it. They didn't. Nathan Cleary too good, but.
Oh, dude, Ezra, like, Reynolds has gone off and Ezra Mam's come and scored a try. Like, this is also what you want when your dominant half goes off.
Yeah, yeah.
But
and
you
Ezra
would
just
be,
stands the fuck up.
As Adam Reynolds, you would, in a private moment,
I don't
like,
even,
when you're talking
I
to your wife, you
publicly.
Would be fucking ropeable.
Yeah, yeah. He would have been so dirty.
Would you like another one?
And, like, every single Rabbitohs fan, Archie included, was furious.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, because it's like, what the fuck are you doing? like, not even because, like, he's a good half.
Yep.
It's just like, no, we fucking care about our club.
That's also
and our
not the way to fucking treat someone who's, like, won a premier, who broke the drought, bruh.
Right.
Like, and his and was still good.
And but also the last possible player that could have come through from born and raised in Pitt Street, Redfern. You know what I mean? Like, he was the...
Yeah, yeah.
Like, there's not going to be any local Redfern kids really...
Well, now it's like, you've got to find... Oh,
Tyrone Munro.
You've got to find local fucking Beaconsfield kids.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah, there's probably a few coming through, but to have a local boy like that break the drought, that's a hard one to fucking brush.
Yeah, it was
He was just
crazy.
But like...
But again, there's
he was still good. That's the point.
He is like, still good.
He's still he played a fucking grand final. Yeah. He's still good. Was still good.
Is
dumb
good.
Decision. Like, it's a dumb decision. And then
and now they're fumbling around trying to figure out what
Dimitri's
to do.
Dimitri's like Ilias is going to be as good or if not better than Adam Reynolds ever was. And you're like, well,
and he started showing signs last year, right? Like, he started playing a bit harder and everything. And then fucking comes out of the gates.
But
like
Ilias
fucking...
is young, bro. You know what I mean? Like, halfbacks with experience are fucking rare. Good ones. Like, they're not that good until they get a bit older. Cleary's an exception.
Cleary's
a massive exception, right? So they'll go, oh, okay, we're going to get rid of a fucking all-timer who won comps, who's still great because we don't want to sign beyond a year, which basically
there's something
get the
else
fuck
to
out.
Play there. I don't know.
And then they go, oh, Ilias, you're the man. And then they've dropped him.
Yeah, was there
they got
injury?
Burnt by Sam Burgess and Greg Inglis where they re-signed them both. And
then had to just put them on the coaching staff.
They were
staff.
Injured as fuck and they had to put them on the coaching staff.
Oh,
and
let's
the,
not
like,
forget Sam Burgess' shoulder was rotting from the inside.
Seriously, that's it. Well, Sam Burgess on reception on $700, like $1 million a year. Hello, welcome. Folks. You're going to need to sign in here, actually, because we're a club.
Are you inside the 5K?
Juniors
scanning licenses.
Yeah, exactly. That's
inside the 5K. Well, just refer to the map over here. sorry, mate. The radius is the radius.
Yeah, he's the highest paid checking guy of all time.
Sorry, mate.
I used to have to do that at a sailing club, and I was like fuck this. I let everyone through. I was just like, this is so much admin. Come on in, bro.
Yeah.
Don't tell anyone.
Really, you're all not from here.
But just go, just looking at the expense bill for secretaries.
Why do our secretaries have to get physio two times a week?
Yeah.
Why's that physio going to Vegas round?
It's an arthroscopy penciled in. What the fuck's going on? Yeah.
The secretary's doing fucking Pilates with Helen.
Oh, fuck. That's good.
Why does the secretary talk to the coach like that?
Yeah. Oh, shit. So it's up to your hammy. That's not even what his injury was. Give it to Pappenhausen, please. Warbrick. The
back
brick.
Back inside.
The brick.
Back to Lazarus.
Let's get a game here.
4 day into Corey knockout. You reckon young Adam Reynolds, Corey wife, childhood sweetheart. Do you reckon the All Blacks wrangled him into a few games?
Oh mate, yeah.
Has he played in a Corey knockout role?
But that's what I dare say.
Do you have to be?
Yeah, you have
indigenous?
To be Corey, but it's kind of like if you're 13 and one of the boys. Like,
yeah.
You live in Redfern, I reckon you get.
I played in a Pacific Islands tens tournament. Because I was just like, yeah, kind of. Yeah, fuck it.
Yeah,
get in there,
you are definitely big enough. Yeah. It's a final, so.
No one is going to question it.
No.
Like, we can't narrow down
that.
What country.
That's, yeah. No, you're definitely, you are Pacific Islander, I reckon.
You're big? Yep, that's fine.
Ball playing prop.
Yeah, you played a nylon string guitar at the train station in high school.
You do a terrific rendition of Tears in Heaven.
And when did you get big? Like, when did you have your growth spurt?
Oh, I was always, you know, top 1% height-wise.
Just always.
But the spurts were there,
I think
too.
They call it percentile when it's, you know.
When did you get to 6'4"?
Bricks in. Oh. Shit, we got a game here.
In year 8 is when I started hitting my head, getting on the train.
Mm. Oh, shit.
And I had a week where I had fucking cuts and shit on my forehead.
Because you just weren't used to, like,
that must have been
the
spurt.
World around you.
That's one of the great spurts all the time.
Your legs were aching as a young boy?
Heels.
I had heels as well. My heels were fucked, and my knees.
But then my feet were the same size as my age from when I was 13 to when I was 17.
What size foot are you?
17.
That's fucking, I was, they're
Thorpe's.
Yeah, they're huge.
Thorpe was a 7'8".
Was he a 7'8"?
Yeah, I think he was.
Yeah.
You ever thought about swimming?
I've thought about it. Show us the length on that.
Yeah, can you put that up to the camera here? Look at that. And here's my shoe
previous commenter.
No. He'll heel it.
I'm just trying to
lay it on top.
I think I'm like an 11.
Damn.
Look at that bitch, dude.
But
look at that.
It's a wide foot.
Oh, dude, it's wide
so
as fuck.
I've got to get the fucking 17 2E from over. Like
is the equivalent to like a double E breast cup or some shit, you know what I mean? But for your feet.
So is that a 17 extra
what
wide?
What am I here?
17 wide.
I'm a US 11. Whatever the fuck that is. What, you know what fucks me off? I understand there's like, you know, we've got metric systems and whatever, the imperial. Like, why can't we just have a unanimous, ubiquitous shoe size?
And if we do, I think it should be the European sizing.
I don't mind that.
They're like 48.
45. Yeah, what am I? I'm a 40. I'm a 45
as long as
and a half.
It's ubiquitous, I don't care. Yeah.
Because then men and women are the same, right?
Correct.
With those numbers.
Because right here, I've got on this shoe right now, I've got US, UK, French, Japan, and Chinese. I'm a 290 in Japan.
Well, the French and the British are never going to agree.
They're never going to get along.
No, they're not.
That's never going to happen.
They should consolidate for sure.
Yeah, they really should, especially in shoes.
Churchill asked them, actually.
What?
World War II.
Can we agree on shoe size?
One less thing.
He was like, let's fucking join forces. Like, if you took anything to make you cunts fight.
Yeah, right.
And they were nah, bro.
I gave him the metric. Fuck.
But I mean, if we can agree on time zones.
Right. You're right.
You know, we need to start fucking agreeing.
Calendars
on
shit. And
shit.
Yeah. Well, times, but time zones are pretty flexible. Like our mates down in Adelaide have gone, well, we're half not going to do an hour, we're going to do half hour.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but that's because they're all fucking weird there, right? Like, we're sort of like,
who's doing a half hour?
But no one's going there. So we're sort of like, do whatever you want. Like, you can call it Thursday if you want. Like,
for those 18 months of the Super League, can you imagine the curry everyone went through with that half an hour time difference? You know, like, because no one knows half an hour. Like,
No. It's not enough to mean anything.
You
may as well do 15 minutes, mate. Like, what are we talking about?
And you miss a good part of a football match if you're 30 minutes off.
So what do you reckon they should be, just east coast of Australia?
Make a decision, right? Like, if you an hour. Do an hour.
But then does that mean it's going to get darker earlier, or it's going to stay...
Listen, all I'm saying is a half an hour fucks everyone
off. Can't
figure
that out.
It's just too annoying.
Mm. It's unnecessary.
But it's a sunlight thing, right? It's like for the cows.
But like, if you went through, if you go through a global clock, right? Mm. There are very few places on the planet where you'll find a half an hour discrepancy. Yeah, Our friends in Adelaide are one of them, and they're probably the only ones.
And you know what's even weirder? Broken Hill in New South Wales follows Adelaide time.
Does it?
Yes. I mean, that's fair enough, isn't it?
Because that's their closest big spot.
Yeah, but they're fucking weird as shit.
No one will know what I'm about to bring up here, and no one will probably ever know. Maybe the people sitting on this couch. But there was a period in the hitman's life over there, as the Storm looked like they're going close. Where you moved to Broken Hill.
Yes, there
for
was.
Like a radio job.
Yeah. And lived with that old cunt.
You lived with that old alcoholic. Yeah. And you documented the whole thing every day.
Wake and
Have you still got that?
Yeah, I've got
it. Dude,
somewhere.
I'd love to see it again. And it was like, this guy was the most raucous alcoholic, and you would just document, like, come
I met him
home.
In the pub.
Well, like, filming him?
No, photos. Like, photos, dude, it's so funny. I can't believe you haven't shown it to him. Home and, like, the sink's filled with long
necks. What he'd do is he was a proper outback fucking wake and fright drunk. And he'd wake up in the morning, and I was doing breakfast radio shift. I'd come home from the breakfast radio shift, like, winter in Broken Hill. It's so cold and dark. I'd come home and I'd be like, stretch. And he would be on the couch drinking. What he used to do was he'd keep a flagon of port in the freezer overnight and then pour it out into a pint glass like a slushy, like a real drinker. And he'd sit down, and I'd sit down and have a smoke with him, and then I don't know anyone in town, so it's like...
sling us one.
It was a little bit like that. I ended up getting... And then I didn't last there that long, but we, you know...
Dude, but the way you documented it, what did you call it? Was there a name for, like, the series, or was it just...
I wrote it up somewhere.
He'd like, post these photos and write, like, just a little bit about, like, what was going it was so fucking
good. He liked my bedspread. He was
good.
So pissed. He liked my bedspread. I'd been out for the day, and he was so pissed. I came home, and he was nailing it to the
wall.
But was this not the case, Hitman, that you actually rented this bloke's house under the proviso that he was fucking off?
He was leaving.
And then when you moved in, he just never left.
Well, no, what happened was I took
the vibes.
I know, he was in the pub. Yeah. I'm in the pub.
I like this guy.
The West Darling, which is a fuck back then anyway, was a wild pub. And he was at the bar and he heard me talking like I'm looking for a place to stay. And he goes, I got one for you. I'm about to go travel around for a little while. We can do a lease and I'll get out of town. You can have my house. Don't worry about the fucking bond, mate. Don't worry about all that. Like, proper drunk pub shit. And I was like, absolutely. So I walked down from the pub, went to the newsagent, bought, you can buy a lease still, probably still to this day. And we signed it. And I go, I got one more night in the pub. I'll see you tomorrow.
What time was it?
What?
If you can go to the newsagent. And cop a lease.
Man, I'm drinking in the middle of the day. Like, I've moved to this. It's wake and fright out there. That's all you do. You play two up and you drink and you fucking go to the races and then you work at some point, usually in the early morning and la, la, la.
Because you can play two up there year round.
Year round.
That's fucking, I'd love to go.
I was very lucky while I was out there.
Why is that?
Why is that? Game, dude.
Because of the shift work, right? So when the 6 o'clock swill happened elsewhere in the country and they were bringing in all these federal laws about drinking, Broken Hill.
Dixie.
All good. Thank you.
Smart man.
Broken Hill had this fucking rebellion. And they were like, no, we got people finishing work at 2, 3 in the morning. They're going to go to the pub after work. There's no 6 o'clock swill here.
Yeah.
Yes, please. And
or maybe a little
swill. There you go.
I might get some more ice for the boys.
Yeah, get some ice. You got some ice? Yeah,
so, yeah, they never really brought in – they were never able to bring in proper drinking hours in Broken Hill or ban 2-up. which was happening at the same time.
Two Up is just the best game.
But, I mean, is part of Two Up's charm the fact that it's one day a year? Like,
or in Broken Hill.
If you can play Two Up year-round, it starts becoming a pretty sad Two Up circle.
Yeah.
It's like, dude, you know,
there's nothing sadder than a sad two-up circle. They're really, and Anzac Day, like, you have some great ones, and then you can sometimes you'll find yourself in a venue and you go,
yeah,
this circle ain't it. Get me
out
of here.
I'm not popping here.
Go. Well,
But you know those, like, perpetual stews? Like, they're just cooking forever and they keep adding things and you eat from it, but it's always cooking?
Yes.
That, but like a two-up circle, 24 hour a day, always going.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, like, that would be fucked eventually.
And like a never-ending two-up circle.
Yeah, 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 where people sub in and out.
It's like purgatory. Yeah. It's like, fuck, dude.
But Broken Hill feels like purgatory too, because they still all, in these towns, because of the mining routes, I guess, they still all adhere to the club thing. Like, you know the clubs where you grew up, you got the fucking... whatever club.
Oh, like the Leagues Club, the RSL, or whatever. Club. Yeah.
They absolutely live by them still to this day. So you've got the Workmen's, you've got the Musicians, you've got the Democratics, you've got all these clubs.
Yeah.
And when you're not... So when someone... They don't ask where someone's from, they ask where they drink.
Yeah,
where does he drink? Oh, he's from the Workmen's. Oh, he'd know so-and-so then. Like, that's how they operate. And they don't follow... It's an AFL town because it's so close to South Australia. They do not follow the AFL. They follow their 18-game round robin, four clubs. And it's the weirdest comp. It's North, South, West, Central. No East, fuck it. No East. And they have an 18-game round robin, and that's all they talk about. You don't,
18
you don't,
games is good.
And you don't, I, you don't,
for
you,
a fucking round robin.
You don't see any, like, you don't see jerseys of, like, proper teams. It's like,
Are these two-up pits like a bender that just doesn't end?
Well, it's usually
a
lot of people in those industries are shift workers, so they're in town and they're hot, you know what I mean? They got cash and... Truckies are on fire.
But they're just running 24/7?
Well, I don't know. I'm sure it's a pub, right?
No, it's Thursday, Friday, Saturday nights.
Okay, right. Yeah. Well, and I was just wondering if there's like always a pit going. You
like
know what
the,
I mean?
Like it's like Vegas, but in Broken Hill and just for two up.
Yeah, it's exactly a little bit like that. You should look at this film. It's on Stan now called Wake in Fright. And it's basically set in a fictional Broken Hill. It's a fucking crazy
Is this a
film.
New film? No. The name sounds familiar.
Yeah,
I was
it's
like,
from back in the day. Don't accidentally watch the series based off it. Watch the original film. They lost the film for 40 years just because back in the day, if you had one copy, you just lost it. And then they found it in a warehouse in L.A. because they'd submitted it for awards. And that was the new last copy they found. And it's about the craziness of towns like that where it's just gambling and piss. And they've made a horror film out of...
Hold on a second. What's going on here?
Everyone seems to be bung.
It's a horror film?
It's a horror. It's a thriller.
Okay.
But so see, that's about your trip to Broken Hill.
And it was like that.
Like, the way that I remember the images you shared and the way you described that gentleman, like, I wouldn't be shocked for you to, like, show up in, like, a serial podcast series where, like, he's murdered someone or you've killed him or you've died there. Like, the town, the whole thing seemed like a really etched. Well, did you see The Last Stop, Larimer?
Yeah, it's a bit like
on
that.
Netflix? Oh, that place was fucking
etched.
You get seduced
by these places, and I think I got fired from the radio job just at the right time.
Did you get fired?
Yeah, I got fired.
How the fuck did you get fired out there?
Because I didn't know what AFL. I didn't know the rules. I didn't know anything.
Oh, was just like that? Was that it? Yeah, I thought. Yeah. You didn't tell us you got fired. I thought you just quit because the place was a
shithole. No, I got fired. Comes out now. I haven't got many jobs. But yeah, that's the yarn.
Wait, why'd you get fired?
Because I thought, fucking Brecky Radio. Here we go.
Oh my God, dude.
That was a scene.
You could have flicked
ball.
He
should have flicked it to Ezra for his fucking hattie.
Yeah, we say as we can't even fucking lift like 15 kilos on a bench press. But
should
I get
flicked
it.
Him.
Oh my God.
Oh.
This game's on for young and old.
It's crazy that you couldn't get your head around AFL because one of your great skills is that you can move to Sydney having never been before and within like 15 minutes you have a greater understanding of every subculture in the entire fucking state than like anyone.
But AFL is very cerebral. Like you need to fucking have spent a couple years on it before you can fucking talk from a media fucking... You know.
It is tough. Well, we've been doing a sports podcast for 8 years, and I still don't know what the fuck's going on. I went to my first AFL game last year.
Really?
Yeah.
And what a day. day that was.
It was actually. The Swans beat the fuck out of the Eagles. It was like a record score.
Nothing better than going to an AFL match at their home ground and then pumping someone.
Yeah, and we were with a former West Coast Eagles player and we're like, your team fucking sucks, dude.
But it was good because he actually explained the game to us. I'd never had explain the game to me before.
Backchat podcast, Scully.
You're basically just trying to get loose from a tag. So it's like, it's just possession. Oh. It's just numbers.
Look at this cut on old mate's head here.
Ooh.
Dude, it's like a proper gash. Like, they actually haven't taped the gash.
There's a bit of Tim Zill about that for Katoni.
He's from a similar part of the world to you, Eddie. He's a willow boy.
Oh, bro, they have not taped that gash.
Katoni's a
willow
boy.
That's the worst taping I've ever seen, dude. I mean, they've taped above it and just squeezing blood out.
I actually didn't know he was from Willow.
Similar story to Tina.
Ferguson's from Wellow.
Oh!
Yeah, no, but he's got the Tongan dad, so it's a similar story to Tino. Just must have gone bush and played footy out there. There's so much blood coming out of his head.
Dude, they've taped it above the gash. Look at this. There's like a split in the middle of his eyebrows. That thing's going to scar up. Manson style.
Look at Kevin.
Kevin's
so stressed.
Kevin's actually Kevin's the funniest coach, I think, in the NRL.
What's with the Broncos and a pretty fucking aggressive Czech shirt?
Yeah, I know.
Oh, no, the moleskin trousers.
No, the checkered shirt.
Like the Czech, you're trying to say something with a checkered shirt.
But
like
you
that.
See people, like you'd know from DJing, you see people out. You go out in the valley and then you go out in Sydney, right? Try that as a young man. And the dress codes are so different and they're so conservative. I mean, the leather shoes is such a big thing for young men in Brisbane. You can't go out wearing Converses for a night out.
So you could have put your leathers
on. Yeah, and a button-up shirt's the safest.
Really?
Like, yeah.
They'll
brush you at the door of a nightclub if you're wearing something that's not
that
up
place?
To scratch.
Like
a T-shirt.
Normanby.
Yeah.
That's the button-up kind of check. Yeah. Gingham, whatever the fuck it is. That's a very, like, Normanby situation.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's just the publicans just say, well, we got to fucking filter out the riffraff. So you end up with the naughtiest fucking blokes wearing checkered button-up shirts.
Because the Valley, I think, has changed a lot, though. You can and around there.
Yeah, I mean, hip-hop clubs you can wear shorts into. But
Sorry, Archie, back to you here. Fun fact, someone says here, Big Dongs 420. Fun fact, Waking in Fright is one of only two films to ever be shown at Cannes Film Festival twice.
Yeah, right.
What's the other one?
That's from Big Dongs 420, so I don't know.
when they found the copy.
Thank you, Charles.
Big Dong 420.
Yeah,
mate, who else is it going to be?
He's got a big dong as well.
That would have been after they found the copy of it. But it's from that era of Australian film known as Ozploitation.
So a lot of these films. Who's a victim here? Oh, I'm being exploited.
No, it's like, you know, there's blaxploitation and mexploitation and
Ozploitation. Yeah, but fuck Ozploitation, dude.
But that actually influenced Tarantino a lot, and you'll see it in his films. You see the Easter eggs, like he'll have a 4X sign in the background.
Really?
Or in Django, he's got those two random Australian characters.
Well, at the end.
Yeah.
Well, it's him and two Aussies.
Yeah, yeah. So he's very influenced by that era of Australian film.
I've heard that. I've heard that he froths that shit.
Mm. He's also a big foot guy, isn't he?
Yes, I've heard that.
Oh, really? Mate, he'd be coming if he was watching this.
Yeah, but
Australia.
I'm not surprised by that. I'm not surprised by
that he's a foot guy.
I think, you know, generally speaking, generational creatives need a quirk.
Oh yeah, a kink.
And you just hope it's not like a R. Kelly style.
It's just like
I'm just going to suck some toes and be out of here.
Or just film Uma Thurman and Salma Hayek's feet as much as possible in every scene.
Yeah, well, or even just a sort of some B-roll. Yeah. You know what I mean? We don't need to put it in the film, but I will get just a feet. Fucking couple of hours of it.
Some just-in-case stuff.
yeah.
That one where it's like, if it wasn't for Harvey Weinstein, every film Tarantino made would have just been feet with him saying the N-word. That was all Harvey Weinstein was good for, is reining in Tarantino's fetishes.
All right.
we got a trivia question. We'll park the feet for a moment.
Yeah, we're getting some
Zach from Brisbane. Place. Trivia question for Tommy Burns. Which WWE/WWF legend born in 1949 was adopted?
Ric Flair.
Bang.
Woo.
Bang. Didn't even need the next part. I want to just back to feet.
That's a fluke, by the way. I saw that in an Instagram like maybe a couple of weeks ago. It speaks to my algorithms.
One of the great characters, just the nature boy. Like we don't.
The
really
fact
know.
That cunt's still alive and still wooing at like pubs and shit.
They
like,
put him in hip hop songs.
Dude, I saw a video of him the other day. He's at like a cafe with like his family, smoking a joint and like going like. And he's so old now. He's like doesn't have hair anymore. But it's like whatever he's got left is dyed blonde, and his skin's tight. And he's like, oh, woo, and like smoking a joint. Like, Dad, you can't smoke a joint. And he's like, I do what I want. I'm Ric Flair. You're like, Jesus Christ,
it is the
dude.
Gators.
We were at Secret Garden, a mate of mine's festival when it was running years ago. Probably fucking approaching
you,
10 years ago now.
Secret Garden.
I played a few of them. Yeah,
oh,
yeah,
did
yeah,
you?
Yeah,
yeah.
The best.
Yeah.
Anyway, Streety was like he was basically a stage announcer. He announced acts and get the crowd going in between sets.
Harry Grant might have just scored here. Sorry, punters and dribblers, just to send it to. There's a kick to come. Fuck, this will be a thievery if the Storm win. Carry on.
And he went as Ric Flair, and he's wooing the whole time and shit. Day one, Streety goes hard in the paint, loses his voice. And, like, we're at Secret Garden for the next 2 days, and he has to start, like, gesturing for shit. Like, he's sitting there at Benders at 5 a.m. He's just sitting there nodding and, like, pointing.
And wasn't he emceeing? He was emceeing, like...
Well, he couldn't do it.
He had to give
day.
Up his emceeing.
He had to
give
it up. He's like, I can't speak.
Point at the stage and be like...
Yeah, he had to learn Napland. Is that who was it?
Napland. Well, you are trying to get a kid into school.
But with your Brisbane people and their leathers, yeah. Their leather shoes. when does a young Brisbane kid get his first pair of leather shoes?
Like when you hit the town and you go out in your Converses, or this would be 10 years ago. I'm trying to recall, but I still dare say some of the places you'd want to get into, like where the footballers are, for example. That's where you'd want to go.
Mm.
They'll be having those kind of dress codes.
I mean, Sydney 20 years ago was that.
Yeah, right.
Like, wrong shoes, mate.
Yeah,
dude, I remember
You couldn't wear Air Maxes.
I remember, after school, you get fucking...
Absolutely not. If you try to get into a club with Air Maxes on, fuck off.
Yeah.
No, I
try, by the way, to Tyron Wishart, not Harry Grant. We're great friends of the Wishart's. We love the Wishart's.
Shout out to Rod, Callum, and Tyron.
Where are the Wishart's from? Are they Central Kew?
Wollongong. No, Gerringong stock. I believe.
So similar to the Lees and.
Dude, like Rod Wishart, who's a New South rugby league legend, but you know, 20 fucking Origins. Where he was at a golf day at Shorty's a couple of maybe end of last year, and we were in the same group as him, and it was like
huge.
It was like you're fucking 60 odd, Rod, and you're the vascularity is just breathtaking. Like you still have a six pack.
No, breathtaking.
Your calves are absolutely fucked. Like, I couldn't believe what I was seeing in
bus
terms of,
cars.
Like, vascularity.
Yeah.
The great Rod Wishart, 55, Jaron
Goldstock. Call it 60.
He played 22 games for the state, Tom, 5 tries, 17 games for the nation, 13 tries. Like, he was just spinning old war stories, bro. And I was... Fanboy is the wrong word, or maybe
no,
it's the right
not.
Word. But like, I,
no, it's not.
No, but even like, I was getting like, I was prepared to blow the man. You know,
yeah,
like that's where
it's
got
it's
to.
Awe.
Yeah,
it's beyond.
I was in awe, right? Yeah. That's beyond fanboy. Yeah, yeah, exactly right.
Cock and awe.
He just so strong, so muscular, such a presence. Fantastic. Big shout out to the Wishart's.
Just quickly, this would be a robbery, and I don't mean in a bad way. It's like one of those. Sort of like I'm thinking you Ned Kelly robberies, you know, like if the Storm were to come away with this, this is bush ranger sort of robbery.
Yeah, Kevy would be drinking lots of bottled water right now.
Oh, he'd be and a short kickoff goes wrong. Oh, no. Tristan.
Trizzy.
Joshua Dugan, did Eddie see a load of blokes in green shirts at the Restobar on Friday? Yes, I did. Just so you know. Saw you.
Yeah, nice.
Saw you there. Shout out to the rest of our
Oh, you in Dubbo last week?
Oh, fuck yeah. You been in the Resta Bar?
No, I haven't been in the Resta Bar, but I have a mate who's a subcontinental gentleman who said it's the best curry he's had in Australia.
See?
Yeah.
People think I talk shit. I know curries, baby.
Have you heard of the Dubbo Resta Bar?
I've heard of it.
Yeah. I want to go, dude. I'm so keen.
Tom, it's going to blow your fucking socks off.
I'm not going to eat for maybe like a couple of days. I'll fast. He says before he eats a full meal and then drives to Dubbo. But
what we would do is we'd fast all day and we'd get the afternoon flight.
Yeah, get up there.
Get up there and get into it.
Very stoned.
Fast all day. Get really stoned before the afternoon flight.
Yeah, we'll call it the 6 hour famine.
Yeah.
Get up there and just
6 hour famine.
Yeah. You can donate.
Yeah, you can donate to it. Yeah.
That little box with the fucking angular front on it.
Yeah.
Pop a coin in. It's all going to a curry.
Yeah. And to the flights up to Dubbo because driving would be a nightmare.
Apparently they get around 10 Range Rovers now, the rest of our run.
Oh, good, dude.
So that's just a feel-good story.
Well, and maybe they owe you some.
There's a lot of business coming through Dubbo.
They're also looking to franchising. They're going to Newey.
Yeah, they are. They're opening
in
Newey.
That's a huge play.
Yeah, we'd like to bring him to the East.
But have an equity stake.
No, fucking, we're not doing it for fun, dude.
But it doesn't. I can fuck with the city. We go.
Oh!
Try time.
Wow.
Try time.
Wow. Look at this kick.
You don't beat Melbourne.
This is very
Lazarus.
Dude. Very reminiscent
this
of the
is Lazarus,
final,
dude. This is Lazarus, dude. This is Lazarus.
They've come back from the dead.
They have come back from the dead.
At Lazarus.
Was this not their longest existing streak against someone?
No, but it was because I'm pretty sure that the Brisbane won down there last year. Zach from Kiama? Fuck it. Let's get Zach from Kiama on.
Bring him in.
Let us know when he's on, Tobler.
South Coast stock. This better be Rod Wishart based.
Is he on? Oi, Zach from Kiama.
Yeah, how you going, boys?
Yeah, good. How you doing?
Yeah, not too bad, mate. Not too bad.
What's this happening about Rod Wishart?
Is this a Rod Wishart question?
No, it's not a Wishart question.
Is it a blowhole based question?
Because I've been there.
Yeah, blowhole.
I've been there.
Blowhole. And Scoops Ice Creamery, mate. Can't forget that one.
No, you can't.
Very punchy. You got a very punchy pub down there from memory. What's the one where you could get your head fucking turned out?
South Kiama?
Oh, you got a couple of pubs. You got the Kiama Inn Hotel.
Right.
Or Tories. Tories, it was all the Grand.
Okay. Right. Which one are you most likely to get your lights punched out?
Oh, none at the moment. They're all dead at the moment.
Gone soft.
Okay, good. That's good. We actually don't want to kill any business. what's going on?
Killed all the Blues.
Well, my question is, can you convince Neds to put a market up to bet on players that are not going to score? Because you've all gone on Pappenhausen. The last week you all went on JMK. The week before you all went in Whiten. They've got to put something for the punter and the dribbler.
Start laying a few blokes.
Listen, I think the inherent problem with that is that if you were a wily rugby league player, and I'm not here to impugn any of their integrity. But you could put a significant amount of money on yourself not to score, and then even if you got close, you just wouldn't
drop
score.
The ball. Yeah.
Plus, the chances of, say, like Christian Welsh not scoring is quite high.
$1.04.
But you wouldn't get a price. So tell you what you should do, young Kiama lad, is just whatever we bet on, just lay that prick.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Don't follow us.
Find someone else. But listen, we'll put the word and we'll ask. I think they'll probably tell us to go fuck ourselves.
It's a dangerous bet because it's so easy not to score.
Yeah.
It's so hard to score.
But thank you for your call, young man. Enjoy your evening. Enjoy your rugby league football.
Shout out to Phil Gould.
He hung up when you said you weren't going to do it.
No. That phone line just paid for itself.
Wishart, love it.
Yeah, he was a Wishart.
2:55 left. Hell of a game. Hell of a game.
Reminiscent of the grand final, if I'm honest.
Go. If we go over here, we're in.
There's plenty of time. There's plenty of time.
Big man wants it. Six again.
Big man wants it.
Try time.
The Giants.
The big fella.
The Giants.
Stop me, bro.
The Giants.
Stop me, bro.
Fuck
fucking
me.
The Squatch.
The A&E channel. The Yeti.
He's gonna hit the Bigfoot as the try celebration.
Yeah.
I just smelt this stench from 20
meters off. Yeti, dude. On debut.
Come on, come on.
Okay, here we go. A fucking long-range field goal would do this as well, boys. We're in here. We're in the fight of our lives. Come on, Broncos. Fuck the Storm.
We were talking before about the phase-out of the mullet. What you're seeing now is just like lots of hair, not really hanging out the back a whole lot, but just getting rid of the sides.
Simple, Jack.
Mattingly.
I know that character's been cancelled now, but there's a bit of simple Jack in that haircut, right?
But it also, remember, he is the youngest, right? He's 19, so this is the front line of haircuts.
Yeah, this is the coolest shit in the old...
But he's on debut, so you can't tell me that he hasn't rocked the fucking sickest do he knows of.
Yeah. His mate, he went to his mate's like barbershop.
Fucking oath he did. Yeah. I'm getting fresh tonight.
It's like if I go to DEFCON 1, right, for the first time out of Penrith, and you think I'm not wearing a singlet, mate?
also a dog tag.
And a bum bag.
And a dog tag, bro.
You guys did go to DEFCON, I remember.
AM Sunnies.
He went to DEFCON.
I picked up Eddie and Street from DEFCON on our way back to Uni and Bathurst, and they both chose to sit in the back of the car, and I had to drive like a fucking caddy all the way back to Bathurst. It's like, you pieces of shit.
Can you hack, Eddie?
Huh?
Can you hack? No, can you do the
He can gabber. I've seen it.
No, don't drag him out. That's a penalty. You're stupid. That's a penalty.
We're trying to do the tellers.
That's a penalty. Easy. God, that was dumb. It was so obvious. Come on. Xavier.
What do you mean? Well, the tackle was complete.
Amazing.
I tell you what, you're a fucking rugby league fan if you get a flanno in the colour of your team. Like, I was in a purple flanno.
It's the Australian yarmulke.
It is. Melbourne.
Let's go, Bronx. This would be a great fucking
the
finish.
The Australian yarmulke.
Ezra has a...
First tackle.
There's someone out there with a shitload of money on Melbourne who's sweating bullets.
Or on the Broncos. Equally sweating.
But just off the back of the Melbourne, the statistic, which
Broncos
I can't
remember. Paying a couple of dollars to win this game. Smoothie, a great last name. Go. Come on. Go, Tristan. The defense was good there.
Ezra's been electric
50
tonight.
Seconds.
Rugby league, how good is it?
Big man wants it again.
Oh, nah, nothing doing out there.
Nothing here. Get close, though. Let's just get close. Give it to the squatch again, though, right? Like, squatch all you need to do. Squatch it up. No!
Oh, no.
This is Hail Mary stuffing goal. Game over. That's all she wrote.
At least Squatch got a fucking try and
done. I'm happy for Squatch.
Yeah, ball there to Chewy, and there's fucking half a chance of getting
Chewy,
over.
Chewy, dude.
That was a rubbish kick.
It was, but like, you know, no, it just was.
Do they have anyone there that could have slotted that?
It was too deep. It was just too deep. It was just too deep.
Who's kicking?
Oh, the field goal. But
I think it was Tristan.
You got to kick 40 out, though.
Yeah.
The field goal.
And who's doing that here? Who had a rugby union scholarship and then moved over to league when they left school?
Yeah, I don't know.
The 40-meter drop is that's pretty rare stuff.
Fuck, that was a good win by Melbourne. That's a brave win. That's one of those wins when your team wins the premiership and you go, fuck, we pulled some shit out of our ass this year. Like, that's one of those sort of wins you have to have.
Well, that was... It's grand final stuff. Like, you get all the way there, and then the grand final that I watched here was the craziest shit I've ever watched.
One
of the great nights.
The Broncos won and lost it.
Yeah, I know.
It was the weirdest match ever.
No, it was over.
That was actually a
it was over.
Fucking fun night.
The game was over. I thoroughly enjoyed that day. Did we get UFC that day as well?
No, we got boxing.
What was the boxing? Oh, that's right. Terence Crawford and...
Yeah. That was good stuff.
Someone else. Was it fucking Canelo?
Yes. It was Canelo Alvarez and the guy that was supposed to fight Tim
One
Zou,
of the great
pumped.
Dribbly pubs.
Who was that? He fucked him up.
The guy that was supposed to fight...
Wasn't Terence Crawford?
Canelo fucked up that guy that was supposed to fight...
Charlo. What it was,
Look at Gordy's aura.
Look at it. Yeah. Someone said to us last week, dude, can you guys do a live stream of Late Show with Matty Johns? That's us, punters and dribblers. Thanks for tuning in. Boys, thank you very much for coming.
Thanks for having us.
Fucking loved it.
By the way, I'm just going to say this.
Oh, you got something to promo?
Roosters Thursday match, we want Cruey and Chicka on here.
Oh, shit. Listo.
Yeah.
Listo and Chicka.
Cruey and Chicky. Yes.
Well, that might actually be next week, but I think we got Mason and Scope next week. But I hear Cruey and Chicka.
But we'll get them on. We'll get